Last time, our tantalizingly titillating troubadours trounced a trough of troublesomely graduated tadpoles. In other words, they fought frogmen deep in the bowels of an infiltrated vault where stands the statue of a strange motorbiker in twisted scrap metal upon the platform of a shattered stone statue, the make and form of which is long forgotten in the radioactive sands of time. Within the vaults, our friends have found both trinkets and skeletons, yet there is more to see. The gentle stream of water coming through the ceiling of the vault's western wing relaxes one, though the smell of monstrous amphibious flesh leaking through Edgar's backpack does not. Peter has determined that the water leaking in is fresh and clean. He's using the stream to clean blood from his clothing now, while Frank pulls out a metal tin, producing a cigarette and smoking.
Dude, these guys are fucking classy.
What was the scared mouth?
Like 80s war, heroes.
The rat pack, heroes. Bro.
Anybody remember his name?
The scared mouth?
The mouth that's not like a warrior kind of thing. The one that was nervous to come down here.
Who didn't come down?
No, the one that did come down here, but he was like nervous and his dad stayed up there.
Oh, he's actually a human, but he's raised by Mao. And that's Peter.
Oh, yeah,
he has a mechanical tail.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Oh,
that's
dude,
cool.
I fucked up my opening. God damn it. I was trying to fix my mistake, and I fucked up.
Wow.
He's not even going to eat any mousesy. It's going to be just some regular humusy. Okay.
I'm going to go up and go up to the fake Mao that I keep fucking up the story with. I'm going to approach him and just tell him, hey, so I was pretty wasted the other night, and I may or may not have confused you with your dad, and I know the resemblance isn't it's hit that hard. The resemblance is...
It's really uncanny.
He says, wait, you mistook me for my father? And like you can see that he like it looks like bright in his eyes. Like this is probably one of the nicest things anybody's ever said to him before.
I put my hand on his shoulder.
Say, yeah, because you an ugly motherfucker.
and the once shining universe in his eyes, brand new galaxy, has now blazed out to a black hole of despair.
I put my hand on his shoulder. It's like, hey. He's wanting to talk, right? Anyways, you guys have a lot of you guys share a lot of the same personality traits. I think my vision may have been blurry, but I can see the virtue in your heart.
He says, that's very kind of you to say, Edgar. He says, I know I don't look like the rest of the Mao. And, you know, frankly, I do know what I am. But in the end, I know where I belong. And that's back with the rest of my people under the sands.
Wait, you guys burrow in the sand?
you hear Frank groan. Ugh. And you hear him take a tight drag of his cigarette.
Wait, we're all together, right? At this point?
Yeah, we're... Yeah.
Okay.
And he blows out his smoke and he says, we don't burrow, we dig, like everybody else.
I turn back to... What's his name? The human Mao? Forgot
Peter.
His name again. Peter, okay. That's right.
I gave them all real easy names for us, boy.
Yeah, I know.
Biblical.
Frank, Dean, Sammy, and Peter. The three. I learned Peter today. The other three, I already made the connection.
You guys might learn a fun fact about this someday, but go on.
Continue strictly with biblical. Peter. Anyways, I know my deal was with your father, but you seem smart, and maybe you can help us with it if he allows it.
He says, well, I don't think I can renegotiate any deal. He said, but I'd be happy to hear you out. What are you thinking?
I have some blueprints for a project I'm working on. Are you familiar with homunculus? Homunculi?
Homunculi, yeah.
Homunculi. I turn and look at John.
He says, I can't say that I've ever heard the word before, but you know, when you compared some of your information with my dad the other night, it you know, some things were clicking, but they just had very different names. Maybe if I took a look at your schematics or your writing.
I hand him my doodle of a blueprint.
And earlier this day, you read the book to them, right? Everybody heard you read the book, and they have language mastery.
Oh, yeah.
I read the book, yes.
Yes, you read the book. Okay.
Craig over
here. Yeah, so he's able to read your writing. So he reads through it, and he says, wow, this is – I'm not sure I've ever seen anything like this before. And there seems to be – he says, now a lesser scientist might pull some moral objections to some of these things depicted here, but not so much myself.
I'm glad you have the same eye of curiosity I do. Some people would frown upon this, is why I haven't shared it with everybody in my group. Look at Daigle. Like, Daigle's the one with the biggest moral compass. Back in the beginning, he was. He didn't want us killing that... cannibal. Yeah. Anyway,
he says, you know, some of this stuff looks pretty pricey, pretty rare, but I mean, if he says, maybe if we can find hopefully we can find some supplies down here, or maybe when we get back to the surface, there are places where you may be able to trade for some of this, maybe through the Sardashians.
Yeah, me and the Sardashians are a little estranged these days. If you could hook me up with somebody that doesn't mind a outcast of the species, I'd be much obliged.
He says, oh, there's more than one of those. Says, actually, there's somebody who's not too far off from here. It's a place we don't really like to go, but back in Sanctuary, there's a shop, Vault Pickers, actually.
And you're
and
oh, sorry.
He says, now the town as a whole, he says, we don't consider to be safe, at least for the Mao. But at Vault Pickers there, he says, they're very open-minded.
Well, we help you find everything you guys need down here, and you make sure to show me where to go to get... God damn, I can't talk.
Take it easy. We help you, Edgar. We'll get through this. I know you can.
I'm a little hungover from the night before, guys. I just tap him on the back. You help us, or we help you with this. We help you find what you need down here, and you make sure to show me what I need up there. And I reach out my hand to shake his hand. Yeah.
Yeah, he shakes your hand.
That's not the only thing he was reaching for.
I give him like a seductive wink for some reason, and then I walk away.
roll a. Hold on 1 second. Let me open up my grandma porn.
Oh god damn it! I closed mine.
Yeah, you did.
Your grandma porn? What? Yeah. You don't have that playing in the background?
Oh, always. It's just with the audio down, and then fucking. Bell Bib DeVoe's Poison playing while it's going.
All right, go ahead and roll a d20. Five experience. That's a natural one.
A nat one.
I mean, it was out of place. And you're still trying to find out how to do this.
Yeah, so he waits a second before he like fully lets go of your hand, and he like. He narrows his eyes at you a little bit, and he says, I'm not into that.
He will remember this.
Yeah.
I awkwardly walk away. And I'm mumbling to myself that I'm mumbling, and I think I'm being quiet, but it's loud enough for people around me to hear. It's like, it worked on the shopkeeper. Why didn't it work on him?
You see the arc of a cigarette butt and its rotating embers. It flies through the air down the hall over your guys' heads. And you hear Frank say, he clears his throat. Enough of that, you dry dick skin bags. He says, let's get back to work.
What? Oh,
dick. What? What the fuck is a dry dick?
He says, you know what a dry dick is.
I don't know what a dry dick. Diggle, he's swimming in puss. What are you talking about?
He says, you're from the wastelands, right? You're one of those desert dry dicks.
Fair enough.
Oh my god.
Desert dry dick. You think they make a clear eyes for that?
clear eyes for the straight guy.
oh, fuck. Clear eyes.
To recap your memory, as you walk back into the main chamber of the vault, you see the remnants of the destroyed stone statue, the pool still floating with exploded amphibian chunks and a bunch of water. You see moss growing. You see the scrap metal statue of the man in a jacket on a motorcycle with a rifle. And then you see that there is an eastern wing heading down the vault. Of course, completely unlit, but from the flares that you have lit or the torches you have lit, you can see just the entrance of that wing. And then on the north side of the vault, you can see another tunnel that goes down a little bit before it is like there's a bunch of fallen rocks there. That's what you guys see.
Okay, so I guess only one way to go.
Onward.
Lead the way, Frank.
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah, yeah. And, Frank slings down his rifle and starts walking down the hall, the eastern hallway.
I'm going to give him a wide berth in case there's any face-grabbing robots in here.
Did you say a wide berth?
Yeah.
Are you going to hide on the side of the walls?
No, I'm just going to stand a couple feet back. From Frank. Again, in case there's any face-grabbing robots in here.
He's PTSD.
Let's proceed cautiously, fellas.
Okay, so going down this tunnel, you can see that there are, there's a bunch of doors going down this way. But the first four doors that you come to all have titles written on the doorway. The first one that you walk past, it's like a rusty door, and it says biological refinement and food systems.
I kick it open.
You kick the door and it goes, dum. Because it is metal.
Biological refinement, huh?
The next sign that you come to says growth and refining. The next one says chemical refinery. And the last one that you come to says medical wing.
I'd like to check out the chemical refinery.
It is locked.
Shit.
I kicked that door too.
It's slightly higher. Maybe it's a thinner metal door.
I think
that's how that works.
It's made out of bronze. It'd be thicker if it was higher.
Oh, we should have brought, yeah. Maybe it's even thicker. Yeah.
We should have brought Cole down here with us. He probably could have shouldered that thing down. Yeah. Can I try to go through the medical one?
Also locked.
Can I pick the lock?
So here's the deal. It's not so much as locked as there's a lock hanging from some sort of doorknob as it is. It's just a big slab of metal that looks like a door and kind of like has a line in the middle, but it's like sealed up, like right all the way to the edge, you know? It's like there's almost no opening.
Gotcha.
Okay.
It's kind of like doors in video games. They won't let you go through them.
So Peter comes up and he takes a look at the doors and he says, damn, these doors are powered. He says, we might be able to get through them with a heat cutter. But other than that, we would have to turn the power on. And I would assume that the power systems are either behind one of these doors or completely just to shit with age.
Mm. Lindsay, you still got that thing on you?
You know he got that thing on him.
I always got my thing on me.
How many fuel cells do you have?
I only have one.
You got one left.
So I've been looking to get through one door.
We got to choose the right one. Which one do you think has the power behind it?
So what are the doors again? Sorry.
Well, the first one was like refinement of like
food.
Yeah, I assume they filter shit and piss into various things.
To spaghetti.
Yeah.
Should we go to the medical wing?
Because they're looking for medical.
The medical wing might have a backup generator.
Yeah, and that's what they were looking for down here is medical.
Good crack. I fucking say you go through the fucking medical wing. They might have a backup something. Something just gives you an itch. Something tells me we should just cut through there.
The second door was just called refinement, right?
The second door was called growth and refining. And then there's also chemical refinery. There's three refining rooms, and then there's a medical thing.
Well, a chemical refinery could possibly make gas and stuff. So
medical is the last door down.
Yeah, chemical refinery might be where the power is because they would be refining possible power sources there.
Or medical has a backup generator, at least I would assume.
Something tells me, Bonecrag, you should cut through the last door.
He says, Lenzer. Frank turns over and he says, Lenzer. He says, we're here to get into the medical wing, but if you think you can get us into more, he says, like, you know, I'll leave this up to you. You're the guy who knows this kind of shit, so you know, fucking get to work.
Yeah, Lenzer, don't you fucking know?
Can I inspect to see if the doors have any hints as to what's behind them?
Besides what's written on them.
Yeah.
Wait, can I put okay. can I take
yeah,
my
go
dagger
ahead and roll.
And can I put my dagger underneath the door and see if I can spot it like a mirror? Is my dagger shiny enough? Because I have a mask.
You rolled a 15.
No. Yeah, okay, Lenzer, what is your add your wisdom to that? And we'll get to you in just a moment.
Wisdom is a plus zero.
Okay. So, okay. Looking at these different doors. So one thing you do notice as you're scoping down these doors and trying to get more information, you notice that the biological refinement and food systems, that there's like a terrible smell coming from the inside of the room. But you can only smell it when you're really, really close to the door crack. It doesn't leak at all out into the hallway. So you guys actually hadn't checked all of them, checked all the doors. But when you go and check the growth and refining room, it's unlocked.
Oh, nice.
And when I say unlocked, I mean that it's cracks wide enough open to where you could try to force it open.
Well, let's try it.
Can I check the medical room? First question. So my masterwork, is it shiny enough for me to use it as a mirror?
Your knife?
Or my masterwork dagger.
Oh, for sure. The masterwork.
It's shiny enough. Can I use a light source and kind of use it as a mirror and put it underneath the door if there's enough space and kind of see if I can use it as a mirror?
Sure.
Dope. Should I roll my? I got 3 plus perception.
Perceive.
Ask and you shall perceive.
Nice.
Oh shit.
I'm like fucking Sauron.
Okay, So what you see, you immediately see when you turn your knife against the small opening you find under the door, you see that it reflects off of what looks like a metal table leg. And in front of that, like reflecting, I mean, now looking at your knife, you can see a reflection. Something moves inside of the room, and it just moves in front of that table leg for a second and, like, you know, blocks the light and goes off into the other side of the room.
I pull it out. Fuck no! What the fuck? Fuck! There's something in here! I've just been here long enough and it fucking does eat! Got another frogman in here! Get another frogman here! Bullcrag! Where's that fire knife?
You guys help me open
the
door.
Give me the fiber knife!
He says, yeah, you hear Frank. He says, if it's just more of those frog mutants, it's nothing to worry about. He said, those degenerate amphibians. There's something in there,
Frank. Yeah, fucking amphibians. I think this is where the power is.
You think the power's in there?
I don't know about that.
Are you sure we can only get through one door, so...
One door's open right now.
I'm no power attrition. One door's cracked.
Yeah, so Frank says, well, don't convince me, buddy. Talk to Lenzer. He's the one who's got to make this call.
Fucking bullcrap, yeah. Lenzer!
Well, one door's Lenzer. Already open. It's cracked.
We're going to go through the open door first.
Yeah. I just need help opening this thing, probably.
All right. How are you guys going to do this?
I want to just... I think
I'm gonna get in between.
Side.
And I'm gonna push it open. I'm gonna squat in between the crack and push it open with my legs and arms.
Okay, you guys are gonna work together?
I was hoping to work together, but if he wants to try this on his own, let's see what happens.
All right, go for it, Lens.
Oh no,
Greg.
I rolled a two.
Okay, yeah.
All right, yeah. It does not shift. You just do a lot of mousy straining.
Okay, Lenzer.
You hear him squeak?
Okay, Lenzer.
Alrighty, let's get down to it, really.
Yeah.
Stop fucking around.
Okay, just try not to squeak this time. You'll make me laugh.
Alright, what are we doing? Are we just pulling on one side? Are we each pulling on the side?
It's like an elevator door, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, each of us one side or two on one side?
Oh, so it's a slide?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, so I go on the opposite side and I pull.
Okay, sweet. So everybody roll a strength. Who's involved?
Got a 17 on that one.
Nice.
With the plus two.
Let me see.
Right there. Joe Talk.
Hello? Can you guys hear me? Is that good?
Yeah. You're like distorted or staticky.
I have no fucking idea what the hell's going on. And I haven't joined.
Try plugging in your regular microphone.
Okay, are we good?
No, this is my regular microphone. That's the thing.
Okay. So we need to get you a new cable and then have you hide it every time you're done.
It'll turn on, but nothing's working. I can't even hear out of it. But I also have tried it before this computer and have no idea how to make it work.
Yeah, Casey, it wasn't letting me join first off in. Should we just restart clean feed? Because it might be a problem with clean feed.
We just did.
Okay.
I just
gotcha. Both. No, I think it like glitched because I have to go through the same setup every once in a while. I have to like troubleshoot it.
Am I still sound?
Oh, I hear you on Facebook, Joe. Oh, you got it.
Yeah, I know. I just fucking... He tried to fucking pull my PS5 off the fucking counter earlier, or off the fucking TV thing earlier too, and I yelled at him and they cried.
That's a testament of strength.
I got
every
it.
Which way you can think about it.
Yeah, all right, let's comments get back you. Into her.
Can
make
we
sure your Facebook's from
he has a name, Mr. Misogynistic.
All right. Yeah, I know. I sorry. Yeah. All right. Fuck, man. That was a
But if your shit doesn't read again, just go to like control audio.
No, I got it now.
Whatever
yeah,
device manager. And
when I went on the sound thing, it had the sound volume bar, and then the fucking microphone was fucking muted. I don't know.
Yeah, it does, dude. My shit does that shit too. It's hella annoying. It took me a long time to get this shit out.
Season, We should end the season with some music and just play some Frank Sinatra, by the way.
Oh, this season ain't in. Man, this season ain't going to end like that, man.
I think we need an Elvis song. We need the most blackest sounding Elvis song. The one that you know for sure he stole from a black person. And then at the end of the song, we gotta say,
yeah, and their guitarist Peter, guys,
or some shit. Like that.
Hey, have you guys not noticed that he named Elvis them now after the Rat Pack?
There was no proof that Elvis stole any song from any black person other than the five songs that he says the N word in.
Facebook.
Yeah, Nate named
his name
now after the Rat Pack. Yeah. Dean Martin and Sammy Davis Jr.
Yeah, I think so.
Why am I Sammy? Because a black.
They'd all probably been in movies.
Yeah. I didn't know the last name. So musicians. The Peter.
Yeah. You guys ready?
This is a queen.
What's Peter's real name? Peter what?
Our friend.
She's like the sweetest.
Let me get back into it real quick.
And she always talks. She's so talkative.
Our guy failed.
Look at this baby. Mike, wow. Look at this baby.
Fucking Bonecrack. Yeah, Bonecrack failed. He tried to hop into the gap of the door and press it open with his legs and arms and failed. And now was directing
drop
everybody
back in,
like, where
to, leave
where
off
to pull
exactly.
on the door to get it open.
No, we left off of my mic. We're working. That's
canon. We were trying to open the door, which I can slice it right back
and
in.
Then anybody else who wants to help. All right. I love it when you guys help each other. Yep. It's looking.
Yeah.
Yeah. Peter joins in too. And you guys manage to push the doors or pull the doors back enough with a huge groan and the scraping of metal. Just enough for one person to squeeze through the doorway at a time, you know.
I think the groan was more like
first.
Okay.
Into the breach.
That one person was you with your mouse body. Get on with your mouse ass.
You guys pull it through, and then immediately Bonecrag just fucking dives through the door open into the room. Sight unseen.
Shoves us aside.
Bonecrag style, honestly.
Bonecrag style. Okay, so in this door, so inside this door, you can see that there are incredibly dusty, big metal rectangles that are like kind of around the floor. They're a couple of feet high, so they're probably up to like, fucking almost chest level for you. You can see there's a bunch of dirt in there. There's remnants of very dry, dead plants on the surface of the dirt. And you can see that there is all kinds of machinery that doesn't really make sense to you. That's like around the sides of the room, along with a huge wraparound like metal shelf that serves as like a desk all the way around the room. And there's like most of the stuff is kind of like knocked off of the desks. But you can see screens covered in dust, and different pieces of machinery.
I'm going to need somebody else to come in here.
I was behind you. I'm going to take a look behind that desk. You said it was like this round desk. We can't see on the other side of it, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to take a look back there.
I also want to take a look with him. What the fuck kind of mayor's fucking office is this, sir?
Roll a roll, John. Okay, excellent. So you're not entirely sure. You're not entirely sure what you're seeing, but you do manage to notice that there are these tubes that seem to be filled with a clear liquid, and they're heading from like one machine up into the walls, up into the wall leading into the next room over, and then also across the ceiling heading into the other rooms. And there's like a network of these tubes, and leading to that same machine. You see this panel that's kind of familiar from your robotics. It looks indicative of where a power supply would be kept.
I would like to go over there and look for breakers or some kind of circuitry.
Okay. Yeah, you're able to pop open that bad boy. It comes loose with your fingers. And inside of it, it actually looks incredibly clean. And when you look at the part that you removed, it has like a silicone gasket around the outside of it that seems to have locked off this chamber from air and moisture. Inside, you can see that there is a power cell, or actually, oops.
Probably a burnt out one.
Hold on a second. There are three power cells.
Are they burnt out? Because I actually have three power cells that aren't.
Checking the power cells, you can't really tell. You need to plug them into something else in order to find out.
But, is there a switch I could flip or anything like that? Or
yeah, there's several knobs and switches on this machine.
Okay.
Start cranking them out, brother.
Edgar, come here, please. Edgar's also read the book with me, so.
Okay, yeah.
He's also read some of the, we both read the mechanics book a little bit too, so.
Let's see, how do we go about that? Do we like,
I just grabbed the first switch and I just flip it up.
Did you both read a robotics book or a mechanics book?
Oh, I think it was Mechanics for Dummies, huh? Wasn't that the one we read? Or no?
I can't remember.
I think it was.
Okay. So what are you trying to find out with this machine, Edgar?
Let's see how we fucking how we can turn it on. I don't know. Is that what we were doing? I was kind of you kind of signaled for me to come over here. I don't know. I'm gonna start turning knobs and flip a switch and see. I'm gonna look at John. All right, I'm gonna look at John, shrug, and then start turning switches and turning knobs and flip a switch and see if that works.
It's like a couple of like a repairman in an apartment complex just coming in and trying to fucking fix your electric stove. All right, dude. Yeah, roll a d20 and add your intelligence.
Intelligence plus 3 to that 14.
Ooh, wicked.
Apparently, my name is Edgar Nolimer.
Edgar knows shit. Yeah, you actually, after clearing some of the dust and looking over the controls, as you're like turning knobs and messing with them, you clear some of the dust and you find that there is like a power on off switch, and then there is there's a water purification system.
Oh shit!
And you flip it on.
Yeah, sorry.
You flip it on, it crackles, it goes and immediately shuts back off. But when you do that, a few lights light up and a light like shines along one of the tubes and goes like all the way up and like crosses into the other room and then it shuts off.
Do you think there's a miss? I turn to John. Do you think there's something stopping it partway up that tube? Or
how big are these tubes? Can I crawl in it?
Peter and Frank come into the room. So they're probably like 2-inch by 2-inch pipes of water.
Okay.
But they look glass. They might not be glass, but they look like they're made out of glass. They're clear but dusty.
Edgar, you know what things just happened? What things you just turned on the bathhouse for these fucking frog freaks?
We can try pushing it again. I don't want to risk breaking the tubes though.
Is it the tubes that are clogged in it? I don't know. Or is the power just not reach? I don't. You guys, this is new to me.
So Peter and Frank come in, and Frank just says, "The hell is this place? It smells like shit. There's dirt everywhere."
And smell like that's who you came in here.
He says, "Good one, Lenzer."
I also said. You miss home yet, Frank?
Miss home? Yeah.
Yeah. Of course you do. Because that's a fucking candle burning, isn't it? Reminds you right there. Back when you're eating fries or whatnot.
Eating what?
I'm just fucking with you, Frank.
Can I see
I pat him on the back.
Yeah, let's inspect the tube.
Yeah, can we inspect the tube, see if it's damaged?
He shrugs away from you. Okay, so you look at the tubes. The tubes are all intact. It doesn't look like there's a break in any of the tubes.
John, do you think it's the break-a-ma-jig thingy over there? The power? Do you think we need to replace those things? And I just flick one of the power cell things or whatever.
Did the buzzing come from the power cell or the pipe?
Came from the machine somewhere.
Okay, I'd like to... Okay, I'm going to go over towards the machine.
And I should put into perspective also the size of the unit, right? So this machine is like, there's the big steel desk that wraps around and goes around the room and has like a bunch of machine parts on it and machinery. And then this is like, kind of like there's a cut section into that that desk table. And it's about like 3 feet wide and like 8 feet tall. And then there are 12 tubes coming out of it that go across the ceiling and lead out in various directions.
I thought you were going to say something like, let me describe this. So it's about the size of 1.5 Slayton sisters, the 1,000-pound sisters.
Okay, I'm going to go over towards the machine. Edgar, flip the switch again.
Will do.
I'm going to listen for where the noise comes from.
Hey, I flip the switch again.
Okay. You flip the switch. This time, nothing happens.
Shit. Okay.
We broke it.
Fuck it. I'm just going to start looking in the machine to see if I see any, like, scorch marks or degradation on anything or something that looks new. I don't know.
Can I look? We have a robotics book, right? We were reading the dummies for mechanics before. We have a robotics book, right?
Yeah. And, so Peter comes over and he says, okay, it looks like a water purifier machine. He says, are you guys trying to salvage parts? That's a good idea.
We're trying to get the power on.
We're going to play the power on.
Yeah. We're assuming that this box right here will turn the power on for all three rooms. Maybe we can get the doors open.
He says, why would this water machine turn on all the power?
Well, it's powered.
He says, how is it powered?
It went and turned stuff on.
You're right.
How is it powered? Show me. Well, show me where it's powered.
The power cells in this box right here. Look at
it. It runs on power cells.
Okay. I feel like an idiot now. Thank you.
I'm just in the background. I'm going to start salvaging it for parts.
Thank you, Peter. If you're so normal, what you do yourself?
He says, "Well, no." He says, "I'm not trying to insinuate that you're dumb. I'm just saying that I."
You're just saying that you know it all and you know how to do it. Well, power on, boy.
It does appear to be essentially battery powered.
Okay.
Or these might just be backup cells, and it may be fed power from elsewhere. I'm not entirely sure.
Well, can you figure out where the power comes from? Not for this, but to get those doors open, possibly.
He says, if we remove this whole unit and try to trace back the wires, maybe we can find which direction they're leading to. But even if they lead into a wall, they could still go in any direction after they're in the wall.
Yeah. Shit. Okay.
I'm sorry.
You shouldn't be.
God, geez, I'm sorry. Can I salvage it for parts? Say fuck this.
Sure.
Salvaging. Should I roll? Is that a thing?
Yeah, go for it.
All right. Oh, fuck
Holy
yeah.
Shit. Put your mechanics to the test, and fucking Edgar Nozum performs with a fucking nat 20.
Which is weird, because all he's ever learned from is building Beyblades.
is that five experience?
Tops, dude. Tops.
Yeah.
Yeah, 5 XP.
Earlier for your net fail tube earlier.
Yeah, I got that one. But did you give out experience from last?
Yeah, you got 200 XP from last.
Oh, okay, cool.
What XP does everybody have now? Let's do a check-in.
I have 1460.
I have 1310.
1420.
What level are you guys? I'm confused.
Dude, oh shit, mine would be
level 5. Get...
Oh, my shit still says 4. I don't think mine was updated.
Nobody's experience sounds right to me.
And Matthew's like, mine's level 1. What the fuck?
I don't think my shit's been updated. Maybe it has, but.
Well, this is hilarious. Okay. So yeah, you start tearing apart the machine. With that Nat 20, not only do you find the machine, expertly dismantle this machine, you also discover a toolbox in this room with the requisite tools for dismantling the machine. Yeah, so you start using pry bars and screwdrivers and all kinds of stuff to start dismantling it, pipe wrench, and
oh shit,
we lost you, Nate.
Hey, we lost you. Now your microphone's not working.
Oh shit, am I in? Oh,
back yeah, in. You're back in.
Okay, fuck. Okay, you use a pipe wrench, and one thing that you do manage to save before ruining with your Nat 20 is that there is like a central hub where all of the water connects through the tubes, and you stopper it with a few turns of your wrench before like starting to remove more of the machine around that main.
You went out again.
Fuck. So you basically prevent a flood from happening in the room.
Okay. So did I collect anything cool? Oh, you're still going. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you get a high intensity filtration unit. And when Peter sees you pull out that filtration unit, he says, "Oh my god." He says, "That is worth," and Frank finishes the sentence, "a whole lot of links."
Legs? Like blinking around, that's all. I just start waving it around to him. Very important. What does it do?
He says that right there could, Peter says that could probably filter upwards of 500 million gallons of water.
So, Peter, how much is it worth?
A lot. A lot. Maybe even up to... maybe 25,000 links?
A whole lot of sausage links.
He says, but nobody even has enough to pay for something like this. You'd probably trade... I don't even know. That is amazing. So, what you're saying is
it's ours forever and no one else can have it?
Frank says, hey, wait. He says... he says this wasn't a part of the agreement.
No, there's no agreement there, Frank.
No, I'm saying nobody has a claim on this thing yet, but I
think we do now. I have a claim. It's mine. I call it first one dibs.
You didn't even find it.
I mean, I don't care if I found it.
I call dibs. Dibs is respectful.
Whoever silenced it keeps it. I think that'd be fair.
Oh my god, dude, can't talk. So he wants, he was saying, like, piece it out, but, like, split it between everybody? Is that what he's saying, or?
Yeah. Frank says, come on, man. I'm down here, I'm blowing fucking freaky frogmen's heads off. I'm keeping you guys safe. I deserve a cut. This is a big take.
I'm willing to part ways and give this to your entire people. If Peter here and his father are willing to help me with my project. I know we've already had that deal go.
That's a good
Peter, trade. Peter says this is far too valuable to sell. I agree with Edgar. This should be brought back home immediately, because this would allow us to be able to set up an entire a second settlement elsewhere. We could spread our people to a completely different area.
Peter know everything comes with a cost. I think you're willing to pay for it, Peter.
He says, with this, we can move further into the south and retake more of the fertile lands.
Oh,
You see, I'm sure they'd pay you well anyways for returning it, or for offering it anyways.
How would we just offer it as a goodwill?
That's what I would say. I hand it to Peter. You go ahead and hold this. I think you'll benefit.
I pull Edgar to the side and I whisper in his ear, "What the fuck are you doing? You just found fucking gold. You're gonna give away for free. You fucking numb. You fucking are you dumb? Are you dead?" Yeah.
And you hear Frank kind of giving Peter a similar ear beating across from me. He's like, you son of a bitch, Peter. This is the biggest fucking take I've ever seen. You candy ass little human. You fucking.
I look at them trying to be secret about it, but I'm so excited. I look at them like
not even it's very obvious.
I look at them and I look back at Edgar. Cable. You fucking dance, man. This is fucking worth billions, millions. I can't put a fucking number on this one.
Diggle, do you remember how we got here? Do you remember why we're here?
I don't remember why I'm here, to be honest.
This all comes down to reality itself. We're here to save our world, their world, every possible world.
Every fucking world. I hear this world is coming. There's something crazy going on. I don't even know if I'm fucking dreaming right now, to be honest. I could pull my pants down and just take a shit right on the spot. I don't know.
I'm telling you. I slapped Daigle in the face.
Ow! I'm telling you,
what the fuck is Lynx? And is it even a currency where we're going back to?
Big breaths.
Yeah, it'll be helpful when we're here, but what I'm trying to build, trust me, it's going to be a lot more helpful in the long run, and I need to get on him and his father's good side.
Edgar, you're wrong. You're very young. You're not wrong.
If they set up another settlement, they owe us. They could help us out in the future.
We are doing a deity's work, but what I'm trying to do is, well, essentially the same thing.
How about this? How about I let you take this one by the reins? Next one's mine. We'll let you have full three of this control. Go ahead and do what you will. But next one, I decide what happens. You found this fair and square. Not you or Bonecrag or whatever. I was a bit out of it a bit before, but how about you all take the reins for this one? I get next one, though.
If you find it, and I just walk past the table.
Son of a bitch, you cocky son of a bitch, fucking horse.
Frank says, I just.
Horse turn! Something in my throat. Yeah, it's fine. Why not for this once?
Frank.
So Frank says, okay. Now, Peter's a goody little fucking piece of shit, but you know, you guys. I just want to say before we go any further, we find anything else of value, he's like, I want a cut of it. Regardless, I'm supposed to get a cut of all of this work in my job.
Oh yeah, the contract says so, right?
And Frank, that's all fine, but don't you agree that this little unit here seems better fit for all of Malkind? We're not just talking about loot here. We're talking about something that could potentially better your people's lives.
He says, Malkind was here a long time before that fucking thing was made, and they'll be here a long time after it's unmade. So I don't really give a shit. I like money.
Let me tell you something here. We were here long before this has even happened. We're like fucking angels. We came from the heavens to prevent something that we don't quite know yet, but we're on our way there.
Why is this monkey-footed weirdo yelling at me?
I'll save my piece for now, but you'll come back to me when you need some help.
Goddamn.
Yeah, and you can see Peter is just like, he's looking at Daigle saying this stuff, and he's like...
He's all quiet, and then Daigle looks at him, "Shut up, boy! No one asked what your tune says there!"
Oh my god.
I secretly and Bill, I keep taking shots of.
I'm just gonna look at Frank.
And myself, fucking frog, fucking scary, fucking dark place. Where the fuck am I? The posse, the fucking storybook with the fuck wizards. Fucking.
I'm just gonna. I just want to tell Frank. It's like he's out of his mind. He's a monkey man.
Where did the shoe fucking fits? I guess fucking so. We're a bunch of freaks. My shoes don't fit no more anyway.
I'm trying to refrain from telling people we're on a divine adventure.
Diggle's freaking out and he's pointing to everyone. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. Except you, Peter. You're cool. Fuck everyone else.
I stick my tail in Diggle's mouth.
Oh, man. You might as well put your fucking willy in my mouth. That was uncalled for.
You're doing
don't say
work,
that. Cleanser. Don't say that.
Good work, Cleanser.
He's gonna put his willy in your mouth, and we're gonna have a fucking a whole fucking duel situation again.
We're gonna have a new battle of the bangers if you catch my drift.
Hell yeah!
Battle of the bangers. Round two.
It will happen. It will happen again.
It probably will.
No spoilers.
I can't wait. I hope it does. Okay. All right. So yeah, you managed to get some parts from this. I'll say that you also have two uses. You can just put down mechanical scrap.
Okay.
So basically, it's an assortment of like nails and screws and things like that that you're able to salvage from this machine that are still in good working order. You have one circuitry parts, and that's what you're able to scavenge. And that's because you got a really good roll.
So, do I get to keep the tools I was banging around with, or does that really matter?
Yeah. You still have those tools too, so. You can just put toolbox, and it'll just give you all the basic tools for doing machine work.
Look out. Edgar's going to become the new plumber of the group. You can just see me walk by with pride and my armor's fucking hanging down, my ass crack is.
It's a job.
First rule of plumbing, shit travels downhill.
or in the people's wait no we didn't shove shit down anybody's mouth that was bangers on pillows though
you put shit in someone's pocket
oh yeah I did can I look around the room and see if there's anything else noteworthy in here to be looking for
Yeah, sure. Doing a search.
I'm gonna do a
oh my god. Oh,
yes.
Dude, how? Two in a row with another fucking net 20.
I'm gonna crank up my Edgar.
That. Wow.
And just kinda,
14, like, 20, 20. Look at that. You motherfucker.
You get a Edgar.
I'm the new Wilton. That's
nothing.
Oh, fucking time.
Edgar Bonecrag.
Yeah, your bone crack. That's what I'm gonna write on my next thing. See if it gives me good luck. No, actually, you know what it is? I think it's the way I wrote my name, Nolimer.
I think I'm just gonna keep it going. I walk in with Edgar.
Okay.
What do we find?
So yeah, you find some packages that have seeds in them, really old seeds, and you find some chemical soil additives and spare tubing.
Ooh,
can I look at the seeds as you pull them?
Can I write these down in my inventory?
That's fucking stupid.
I'm gonna take them.
You look at the seeds?
Yeah. Look at the seeds. Is there anything I can tell with my
What did Daigle say? No, Daigle said he was doing something. What did you do?
I just looked at the seeds. I was like, well, that's fucking stupid.
Can I inspect them with my 5+ nature here?
Yeah, do it.
I'm gonna get like
if you roll another 20, bro. If you roll another fucking 20, okay.
Get the fuck out of here.
You have to change that last name back.
Okay. What does Edgar think? Edgar, explain what you thought you saw.
Yeah, you check them out.
I think these are peach spits.
Yeah, so you can tell that there are four different types of seeds, but you don't know what they are.
Is that what you said?
Yeah, I meant to say pits. I meant to say pits. I don't know why.
It works so perfect, though, because you're so bad.
I don't know why I said spits. I cracked myself. I meant pits.
I look at Edgar. Oh, you know the man with the green stump? Yeah, you quite notice these. How often did he pull this out of fucking horse dung?
Nate, what did you say that I noticed? I'm sorry.
You notice that there's four different types of seeds and you're not familiar with any of them.
I'm going to pocket them anyways.
Alrighty.
What was the other thing?
You're about to make some arsenic, bitch.
No. Some tubes. You notice there. You found extra tubing, and this is plastic tubing. And then you find some containers that are like chemical soil additives. Like one of them is ammonium, and
this is Nate's room. Is
phosphorus and potassium, I guess. Yeah, I guess it's just the main plant nutrients.
Do you work with that stuff a lot?
What was that? Ammonium?
Ammonium.
I'm going to take all this shit. I'll just... Yeah.
All right, sweet. Yeah, so you find a bunch. So you get a bunch of powdered phosphorus. You get a bunch of ammonium and some potassium as well. I mean, there's basically as much as you can carry, so just tell me how you're going to try to carry this shit. They're all, like, volatile chemicals.
Fuck. where are they? They're not in containers? You said they were in canisters?
Yeah, yeah. They're in, like, these metal canisters that, like, you know, have, like, the labeling for the chemical. And when you open them, the first one, is like, the ammonium is just kind of like this... it's like this gravelly brown kind of shit. And then the other two are just white powders.
I lean up against the door and I look at Edgar. What the fuck are you doing there, man?
Daigle, unless you have something I can carry these in, then don't worry about it.
How about this? You never think for a second that, oh, Daigle doesn't have a backpack. He's useless. He just fucking go around. The only thing he carries around is his mouth and his wit. How about this? I'm going to fucking satchel right here. I'll carry a fucking dong in this. If it means something, tell me, Mr. Scientist Man.
I stick my arm around Edgar and I say, listen.
Where did you keep coming from?
What is going on?
He's a fucking mouse. What do you expect? He crawls when you least want him.
My arms around Edgar. I say, listen. Just tell Frank they're valuable and he'll take them.
Oh, yeah. He's also a mouse. He's also useful as shit.
Cole would come real... Cole would be real handy right now. Peter... Do you have any containers you're willing to part ways with?
He says, yeah, actually, I have extra silicone sampling bags if you'd like.
I'll take as many as you're willing to part with.
All right, so he gives you, well, here, how many is he willing to part with? Let's see. Boop. He gives you two, and each one of them can hold about, like a cubic... Like half a foot, like a cubic half foot of substance. Which is kind of, it was kind of a lot.
Yeah, that seems like a lot.
Edgar!
Okay.
Edgar, this is a weird thing to ask. Can I ask you, this is a weird thing to ask, but why are you collecting dung over there? Do you mind sitting at my bedside when someone just magically fucking appears at my foot?
I don't think we've had that issue since we've been here. Although it was pretty odd.
I don't think so yet. But it'll come again. That fucking poopy striker strikes twice and three times.
We're going to see it happen this time. It's going to be pellets. God damn it, Lindsay.
It's going to fucking happen again. I swear to God. I'm not crazy. It fucking happens. Okay,
look, Daigle. It kept happening before when we were at Miser's. And I admit it was a little odd that it happened in the Lonely
fucking
Tower.
A lot of odd things happened.
I rode a gorilla man.
Odd at the most.
Now, if it happens here, we're just going to have to accept the fact that it's one of us doing it. And I wouldn't rule out yourself. You do drink a lot more than the rest of us.
Yeah, that shit wouldn't be easily scooped by a fucking container, no. It'd be fucking liquid as fuck. Let me tell you something. You know what I think fucking bone cracks behind this? Because now if you shit to the foot of my bed, it'd just be pellets.
Nate, did you say all three of those are powders? I'm not. I know Edgar would know this stuff, but I don't.
Yeah. One of them's like granules. It's basically think just brownish black sand. but like big pieces of sand. And then the other stuff is just white powders. Well, like okay. One, you know, off white and white, whatever.
Okay. So I'm going to put two of those things in those sampling bags, and I have one empty vial. So I'm going to fill the ammonium with empty with the empty vial. I don't know if that makes it less. I'm just going to write vial of ammonium.
Yeah.
And then I don't know how to write out the powdered phosphorus.
Yeah, so just write up that you have those bags, and each of those bags is going to have 4 uses in it.
Okay. So I'll just put 4, and I'm going to put S. I'm just going to put SB by it, and I wrote next to it fucking sample, silicone sample bag, so I'm just going to put SSB. SSB. Okay, there we go. That I should remember it because I left a note here.
SB. All right.
All right, there
you
we
got,
go.
You got a gay
yeah,
boy.
All right, yeah. But to be fair, I'm also going to look at that and be like, what the fuck does Scooby-Doo have to do with anything?
I was just thinking Scooby-Doo for the longest time. It's funny that you said that.
Like, just, I have a Scooby-Doo full of these things. It's like, hold on, guys, I'm going to pull some out, and I just grab a whole fucking... What kind of dog is he? A Doberman? I don't know. I don't know dogs.
Isn't he a great
Dane? Oh, a great Dane. I pull him out of my bag and open his mouth, and all you hear is wee. And I just...
Did you know between us and Scooby-Doo is like, unlike Fred, we don't claim a gang.
No, but we do all rock ascots.
Oh, that's fair. Shit.
Dude, okay, I just sorry. Watched the it's... fucking Supernatural Scooby-Doo episode today.
I was thinking about watching that show sometime.
They had a crossover. It's a good episode.
So 4 for each in ammonium. Would that be just one because it's the vial? Because it's usually one vial is like one, right? Or I don't know.
Yeah.
One vial. I don't know how much. I don't know. We'll figure out the measurements later. That's not important. mm-hmm. Sorry. Just want to make sure.
No, you're good.
All right. Okay.
Yeah, we'll just call it another use. That's fine. Okay. Yeah, so you guys are right now, you guys are standing out in the hallway, and Peter is he's pulled out a small tool, and he's picking out some like dirt and grime that's gotten caught up in the joints of his mechanical tail. As Frank lights up another smoke, and he looks over to he lights up his smoke and he looks over to Wilton and he says you gonna break us into the medical bay lens or what?
I reach out and I take his smoke out of his mouth and I puff it myself.
Now you got
rat. Right, right, I am.
That was hot.
He said he leans up and he pushes himself off of his knees and he stands up and he grabs the smoke back from you and he says, "All right, about time."
Didn't you find a fuel cell in there?
Me?
Yeah. Do you? How many do you have now? I couldn't remember. Did you find one while we were in there?
No, I have one fuel cell. I'm pretty sure. I think Edgar might have. No, he didn't find one.
No, I got a silicone sampling bag.
Got power cells, not fuel cells. These ones, it's just a different type of energy source.
Yeah, you found the power cells.
Yeah, but those work for the guns that you guys had found before.
Yeah, I still have my rifle, I believe.
Yeah, so that charges the rifle, the power cells.
Yeah.
Are we ready to get into this med bay or what?
Let's do it. I mean, what the fuck else are we going to do? We're sitting in a goddamn, hallway.
You can hear the distant sound of the trickling water as it slowly pours down the western wing and runs down to the base of the broken statue and the statue erected above it. The falling of the water into the pools where the chunky corpses of the frogmen now rot.
Beautiful.
To paint a picture.
Now I'm thinking of his soup.
you kind of flash cooked them. Yeah,
we made chowder.
Chowder, frog chowder, dude. Okay, so
are there any weaknesses on the door?
Yeah, roll a twendo.
He's looking for inches. 14. Don't you have a plus 2 or like 4 to perception? Some shit like that?
I have a... Where's perception?
It should be in the skills. It's like the... that one like box that's right kind of next to intelligence, constitution, wisdom.
No.
If you're using like a 5e sheet, that is.
Yeah, but I don't see that.
It's like where all the like check marks are. It should be in alphabetical order. Like just below halfway.
Perception.
Deception. Oh, here's perception. But there's nothing written there.
Okay.
I know someone has like a plus 4. Probably Matt.
Wait, what is the perception for?
Edgar's got some too.
Yeah, I do too.
But Will, yeah, I mean, you're looking at this door and you check on it, move your hands across it, and you find a section that actually like most of the door looks like it's pretty well put together, but you find a section that it feels a bit more hollow, as if maybe it has rusted through partially. It seems like a good part to cut, and it's a large section of the rightmost door, which is all metal. Yeah, you're just looking at these two big metal doors that are about like 8 feet tall, and each of the doors is like 10 feet wide. So it's like a 20-foot entrance to this medical bay room. Yeah, it's really big.
I was just assuming like elevators.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's big enough too. And when you look down at the ground too, you can see that there are like marks, like things have been like dragged in and out of this room before. It looks like do a check.
All of us?
Yeah. Yeah.
Rat crack.
17.
Alrighty,
looks
John.
Like drag marks me.
Yeah, so you can see that there definitely are some drag marks, and that there's also like something has come in here on wheels, or in or out.
Okay. So there might be a cart in there we can use, hopefully.
Yeah, and I guess you can tell that these are, like, somewhat recent.
Oh, shit. Hey, you guys, something's been in and out of here pretty recently. We should probably ready ourselves for anything.
Hey Linzer, since you're a Mao now, you think you can, like, lick the tracks or something in there?
Ah!
Oh wait, was that you that did that noise?
Yeah.
Or was that okay? Yeah, I thought that was my fucking thing.
Did you? He was making the cutting motion in camera.
Okay, so you start burning it.
Yeah, just as John was saying, everybody be ready or whatever.
I'm gonna stand
with a flash of like. Of blue and white light in the darkness, really like mostly blue with like a white center. This flame comes out of the end of the fusion cutter, and you put it up against the. It begins to just melt the metal and make like a clean cut through it. It takes you a couple minutes as you go through. What are the rest of you doing to prepare as he's like creating this entrance through the door?
I have my gauntlet, and I'm standing just behind him. Just waiting. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Kind of with like one arm on him in case I need to push him out of the way.
I'm putting myself at like a medium distance to get ready to throw my one and only phosphoric acid that I have left.
I'm going to throw that good. We don't want a Daigle situation with me. I got enough scars.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
How fast can you make more phosphoric acid?
I'm not sure the speed.
I believe the last time he did it took 24 hours, didn't it?
So I have sulfuric acid now, but I don't have distilled water. And that takes 2 hours. So.
Oh. Okay, yeah.
But I'm not sure about phosphorus.
We haven't really had time to even get a really good rest in, except for at the camp.
Yeah, it's been a little while. You could have took a break before this, but here we go. We're burning into the door. Okay.
Oh, I found it. I have a plus 4 to perception.
Yeah, I fucking knew it. I knew it.
Oh, good. You found what you found before, but better.
Good job. I'm proud of you.
You did good, okay. Pig. You did good. I mean,
all right. So it hisses and cuts through the door. Matt, can you hear us, by the way?
It looks I can like hear you guys. Sorry. We just brought the new cat home. Sorry.
Okay, I just want to make sure. So you hear it hissing and cutting through the door as he makes a large circle, you know, reaching over his head to make it large enough for the bigger people, I imagine. When he gets to the bottom of the door, he starts from the bottom, goes up in a big oval, and cuts down to the other side of the door. And when he reaches that side, it kind of just like shifts down a little bit. So that little gap that was in the door, it like kind of just fills that space. And yeah, now it's sitting there free of the door. You know, it can be. Okay.
Can I kick it?
So Frank is right behind both of you guys, and he's got a gun. He's got his rifle out. And he's just looking in there. He's got the smoke sticking out of the corner of his fuzzy little mouth. His whiskers are twitching anxiousness to shoot.
Can I?
Okay, so dark? I'm gonna kick it and roll to the side. I don't feel like getting shot in the back by this. You know.
Yeah. How are you other guys positioned as this is happening? So like the kick is flying at the door right now. Where are you in Daigle, Edgar?
I'm keeping myself at a medium safe distance.
You already said. I'm sorry.
No, you're fine.
I want to post up on the other side of the door, up against the wall right there with my daggers at the ready.
Yeah, so I think
pops in
against the wall with your daggers at the ready. Okay.
I think if Wilton is, you know, dead center on the right door, I'm just left to him, probably in front of the left door. Or if he was in the center, I know it's a big fucking door.
I'm assuming I'm where it ended.
Yeah, you're right there.
I'm to the left of Wilton when I'm kicking it is what's going on.
Yeah. Wilton, I mean, you can duck back or whatever. You can decide what you want to do as like you see John's getting ready to kick this door in. Are you staying towards the front or do you want to move back?
I'll stay towards the front.
Boom! The door gets kicked in and the metal goes flying inside. It slams into the ground and skids across what you can hear is like metal on metal on the floor inside. And you immediately begin hearing whirring sounds. A bunch of lights come on inside the area. Pew, 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 pew. They burst on from all directions inside of this room. The light is shining out through this little doorway, and you can see there are these like they're these things shaped kind of like hourglasses, and there's four of them, and they have these tubes that come off the sides of them. And they have these mechanical arms, and at the ends of the arms are like they look like almost like perfect human hands, and they even have the texture of like human hands, but they're connected with metal. And you see like out of the fingertips of two of them appear these little needles pop out of the tips of the fingers, and you hear them say, you hear a voice come from the inside. Prepare for vaccinations. Prepare for treatment. Please submit to treatment. Submit. And they begin rushing blindly towards that entrance. Everybody roll a d20 for initiative.
Oh shit. Dude,
we're anti-vax.
What if we already had Moderna?
Damn. You already have Moderna? Oh, well, I mean, try telling them.
I'm clean.
Malferna. I don't know. Malfour.
So are these on like wheels or they got little legs?
In the front they have wheels, and in the front they have these two wheels, and then in the back they have these treads.
Okay.
It looks like the wheels are, you know, for like directing it from side to side, and then the treads to move forward.
If it does attack me.
Oh yeah.
Can I use an ability?
And then Frizzy Frank. I mean, probably, right?
I probably shouldn't do that. We have a new cat in the house. I should be more regular.
More regular? The cat's going to be fucking scary.
Oh, wait, that is regular.
You don't want to get it. You don't want to get startled when you hook line its fucking ass cavity later.
Wilton, you know, what's your modifier for your initiative? It's like your dexterity bonus.
So plus one.
Okay, 17.
Mine's plus zero.
All right, are we talking about dexterity? Because I have a minus one. Okay, so
mine's a plus two.
Stats.
John, that's 11 for John.
12. It'd be a 10 for Edgar and then 8 for Daigle.
Daigle Scotch Snatch.
Oh, yeah.
And then... Okay, cool. I think I got everybody up. And then... Scotch Rag.
Do you remember the French voice night, Joe?
Well, what?
Like we did it for a good 45 seconds. We were just going back and forth with because we were talking about the French and cages.
Yeah.
All right.
I have a goal on this podcast. It was not to talk about the sissy French on it, and you guys broke that rule. No, just kidding.
We're not a bitch history podcast.
There is nothing wrong with you cheating.
All right, guys. Battle. Okay, so the whirring sound begins again, and you can hear that it is like the sound of like the lower half of like this hourglass of the machine. So when I describe it being shaped as an hourglass, up towards the top there is like these bright like kind of like spotlights that come from this central kind of orb, and it goes down to a very thin middle with a bunch of metal rings that go around the outside, and then it goes down to the bottom, where you can hear like this whirring coming from, and you can see these two like kind of tank treads with wheels in the front. And it is coming towards you, and it has its two arms just like pointed out like this, and one of them just flies straight forward and goes straight at, I think John's the closest. Yes.
Oh, shit.
Should have kicked that door, brother.
All right, so it juts its hand out towards you, but it misses. And its second hand, does a 15 hit?
Nope, I got 16.
Awesome. Okay, you're able to deflect the second attack that comes towards you. And then right after you knock that hand back, you hear boom right over your head as Frank fires the fucking rifle twice, right past your head at the fucking robot.
Roll for tinnitus.
Yeah. Oh, shit, that's kind of a thing.
Does that daze me? Or
that's a good question. Roll a constitution, buddy. Let's get it.
And thanks, then my Casey. Con plus one.
Plus what?
Plus one. So 13.
It's not my fault Frank's fucking wild.
Yeah, Frank.
I think you're proficient in that too, so I think it's plus three altogether.
Okay, am I?
Damn, buddy.
But yeah, okay, you pass either way. That's 13. Okay, yeah, so I mean, your ear is ringing, but you're not stunned. Good. And both those shots hit the robot. For a total of... Holy shit, 23 damage.
God damn.
And after he does that, you see him like he drops his clip from his rifle and goes to reload.
Oh,
he says fuck.
As he's not, can I like rush in?
No, it's not your turn. Like, it's Will's turn.
Oh shit, my bad.
Lens your turn lens is later because you rolled an 8, buddy. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Turn.
Oh, my bad. I thought that was our dodge.
Oh, wow. There's one near us because you were next to me. Four.
Dude, I still got my torch in my hand. Can I just torch one of these in the face?
I mean, oh, yeah. Fuck. You do still have your fusion cutter. You want to use it as a... Okay, fucking hell. Go for it, buddy. Yeah, you never turned it off. It happened too fast. Yeah, okay. Is that your roll?
Yeah.
All right, dude. Yeah, plus your strength and shit, dude. That's...
Plus two.
Plus your strength and your proficiency bonus? Yeah, dude.
Plus three.
Yeah, that's going to hit. That's going to hit. Yep, that's 19, I think. Yes, that's going to hit.
Fuck yeah.
All right. So, oh my god, yeah, this is versus a robot. So go ahead and roll. That's going to be fucking...
It's
going to be 2d10.
Nice.
Which one's the d10s?
I think it's the blue diamond.
Yeah, it is.
Because the green one is a 12.
Oh, yeah, I see the...
13. All
right.
Oh, you got a 10 on one of them. Nice.
Nice.
Ooh, damn, I'll see you. I'm okay to keep playing as long as it doesn't Athesia? Ever come because like as long it. As it doesn't ever come up to like evolution, because I believe in creationism, and so if there's anything that happens that is evolution based, I do have to step out at least out of the room while we okay. continue playing, and then until we go back, like something like this, I gotta go pray right now. So I'll be right back, guys.
Hey, except for in the random cases in which because I'm also a toxic masculine male. So if there's anything about
literally, dude, mine you're
does
toxic.
Be evolving huge.
Edgar's toxic is literally.
I am.
Oh, that's true. That's true.
It is now. Oh, it's another one of the robo turn. Okay.
Robots.
So the another robot runs.
What happened with my attack?
Oh yeah.
What you did damage to it? Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, let me describe it too. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, you put. How do you? Well, describe how you want to do the attack. You don't kill it, but
Yeah, rat
boy. I just wanted to like just like melt the face. I just wanted to know how much damage for, like, you did the to light? It. You know?
Oh yeah. Yeah. I mean, you did 13 damage to it.
13. Oh, that's the oh, okay, gotcha. Never mind, I'm stupid.
Yeah, you do 13 damage to the robot. You put your fusion cutter right up into its face, and you melt some of the glass and some of the metal, and you can see some sparks fly out of it, but the machine is still running. And as you're like burning into its face, it says, "This defies protocol." another robot just comes up right behind it and rams into the back of it, and now it's pushing the other robot through the doorway into John, into Wilton. You guys go ahead and roll strength rolls to try to stop this robot from pushing Ooh. Its way through. Not Edgar. Edgar's too far.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
Two, well, three.
That would have been amazing.
Okay. Edgar's back against the wall, just flexing.
What if hands are greasy?
Dude, they don't call me Edgar Swollem for no reason. Right?
That's true.
Is Frank helping us? Is he still reloading?
He's still reloading, and also he didn't do very well at helping. Yeah, he got disadvantaged because he's in the middle of doing his thing. Okay, so it gets shoved into you, and now there's two of the robots. One of them sparks hewing out of the front of it, a little bit of like oil, like glistening, kind of like fucking orangish oil dropping out of it, and some sparks flying. The other one, fresh and ready to go, as it jabs its needle directly towards Frank.
Oh no!
Damn, dude!
And it jabs him right in the neck.
No.
Oh, fuck.
Jabs him right in the neck with a handful of needles. And, yeah, you see the lights go out of fucking Frank's eyes. And, like, the cartridge that he's holding in his hand and, like, trying to, like, put the bullets in. Like, he, like as the needles come towards him, he kind of, like, just, like, puts the cartridge up in the air. And it just, like, slides out of his hand. And he just falls down dead. It's like his legs... His legs went like noodles beneath him as he falls down into a pile.
Is he unconscious or is he actually dead?
You can't tell from where you're at in this battle.
I hope that was a sedative.
And the robot says, "Thank you."
It did its service job.
Here's a lollipop.
at least we know he won't get the flu.
It dispenses two lemon drops. Tink tink.
Your immunization to the flu
is fucking great. Tink tink. Thank you.
successful.
Please comply. Please submit. It is John's turn.
Let's see. So there's a hole in it. They said he was spurting like oil and shit.
Yeah. So, okay, let me describe the field to you right now. So, when it got pushed through the door, one of them got pushed at John, and now one of them got pushed at Wilton. So basically, Wilton's right in front of the one that he fusion cut, and you're directly in front. You guys are kind of separated by these robots right now. You're face to face with a freshie.
Damn. Okay, so I want to try to grab one of the arms and kick it at the same time, see if I can pull this fucking arm off.
Mm. Wicked. New?
No. Oh, yeah.
you go to reach for the arm. You go to the reach for the arm, and it just pulls back its arm, and it says, "I do not need assistance. Please submit."
No, thank you, dude.
I think you have another attack too.
Okay. Right? Since I missed the grab, I'm still going to try to kick it. See if I can get it away from me. But
okay, word. and you still have a you have three attacks now, right? Because you have like your offhand attack. You have like your
I have two hand-to-hand, two fist attacks. It's, I think next rank I get
double
my third.
Fist,
yeah. Oh, okay, cool. Yeah. I can't remember.
Almost there.
Gotcha. Okay, well, that kick is going to also miss. And a third robo comes and runs through the door and starts shoving both the other robots. And now it's getting cramped in this hallway. In fact, John, you're being backed up into where Frank is laying on the ground, because remember, he was right behind you.
Yeah.
So now the treads of this vehicle are threatening to like push you over Frank and run Frank over.
I mean, if I still got a movement, can I retreat to Edgar and hand him my cleaver?
What the fuck?
Daigle also yells, "They've been a fucking centipede!"
Because I didn't have a movement yet. So if I can still move, if I could retreat to Edgar and hand him my cleaver...
Okay, so before the third robo comes through, you do the two failed attacks and you run over to Edgar, right?
Yeah, pretty much. Okay. Yeah, retreat a little bit. Hand him.
Okay, sure. Yeah, Edgar's a ways back, so Edgar's away from this clusterfuck that's happening in the hall. but now that you're not in the way, the two robots get pushed. Go ahead, Wilton, roll a strength save to see if you can resist being like pushed back further, and then I'll roll this strength.
Fuck. Dude, we already get boned.
I push against this.
Y'all
force.
Fucking used all the good rolls earlier with the goddamn jokes. I swear to God.
Go ahead and say what kind of jokes they are. It's recorded.
Tell them what they are. No. Wilton, did you roll? Is that a three? Is that what you got?
Mike, say it.
Did you roll a three, Wilton?
He did.
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't see a pop-up. I wasn't sure if it was an old one. Okay. Oh, of course it is. That's the two John hits. Okay,
he tries to push up against this force.
You get shoved even further back as this other robot like comes out and pushes that robot. So you're now like you're kind of separated from the group down the hall. The only person that's near you is Peter. Edgar is down on the other side of the hall. Daigle's over there as well. Frank's on the ground, and John's next to Edgar. So the robot pushes its way in, and it pushes that robot that John was just fighting, and it rolls over fucking Frank on the ground.
I'm sorry, Frank.
Frank's dead.
And Frank takes some fucking damage.
Yeah, he does. He can't walk. He's not coming.
Oh, no, it's funeral Frank.
Hey, he's the one who wanted to be greedy last time.
Combat Carl.
That robot, you see it like it turns that circle with the light, and the light shines on you three, Daigle, Edgar, and John, and it just rushes straight towards your direction with its stingy hands out, and it goes for Daigle.
Oh shit, can you use my dodge?
Yeah. You're going to have to roll against its roll, right? That's how it works?
Right. Yes. I have tumbling trick as a reaction. Once per round, you can roll a dexterity roll versus an attack that hits you. If your dexterity roll beats their attack, you take half damage at level. That doesn't. Wait, what level am I? Sorry, it's been a minute.
We should all be level. What level five. Are we?
Five. Oh shit! So
I think you have a legit dodge now, don't you?
At level 5, advance to Tumbling Master, and you take no damage on successful roll. I also have improved reflexes. You gain one plus dodge bonus to AC when not wearing a shield or armor heavier than
you. Just always have that. That's just calculated in your AC.
Okay, so.
That's why your AC is so dang high, dog.
Boy, oh my god.
Okay, so it's gonna roll the attack on you, and then if it hits, you roll back. Okay, it hits. That definitely hits.
No!
Well, yeah, so at least I get experience.
Oh no, it's a one.
Damn. It's so weird. We used a lot of good rolls in.
For people listening, the last rolls that everyone has had has been a 3, 7, 4, 3, and 1.
Hey, Matthew,
yes,
you know
they've all been very low. Dang, just got a 1 to avoid getting stabbed in the neck with a needle. So let's see how that runs out. You take 3 points of damage, and you roll a now roll a Constitution save.
Oh, dope.
I think you're pretty good at Constitution. We'll see.
Yeah. Oh, 19.
Oh, Daigle, so you...
I think I get +3.
Yeah, dude, you manage to shrug off... So you feel something enter your body, and you immediately start, feeling sleepy, but you feel yourself resisting it. Like, you're not 100% right now. You're going to get, you're going to experience some negative effects, but you do not lose consciousness.
Daigle's been microdosing fentanyl for years.
You fucking puppet! You take a little fucking prick is gonna stop this man! I'm ready for you!
It says, thank you.
Here's your lemon drops.
Dink, dink. 2 lemon drops fall out the front of the machine. Your safety is my your safety is my desire. all right, and it is Edgar's turn.
Okay, that one that went after Daigle, is that the one near me too?
Yes.
Okay, was that the one that got its face ripped open, or is that a different one?
That's a different one. That's the one that's right in front of Wilton on the other side of another robot. So basically, if you're looking from your perspective, you're looking down a hallway. There's a robot that's in between you and John, and it's fighting Daigle. And then there's another robot behind it. And then there's another robot behind that has its sparks flying out of it. And you assume Wilton's on the other side, but you can't see him.
Okay. Shit.
How do they know really how do they know if you've been vaccinated?
They don't.
I guess they pull their needle out of your neck.
Okay.
Yeah.
there's no way of knowing from just reading a mechanics book of any there's no way of me getting any knowledge of a sprinkler system. I'm trying to make this realistic here.
A sprinkler system. What do you run me through your thought.
Okay, so I was thinking because I've read because we read the mechanics book, but I don't think we ever touched on the robotics one, that maybe there's a sprinkler system and then I can ignite a fire that would cause it to go off and maybe it would short circuit some of them if any of them had damage.
That's but good
the only
thinking.
One that does is Casey's.
Also, Wilton. So we can stay away from metagaming a bit, is we're totally aware of robots at this point, or did we read about
we've
them?
We've already we caught up robots.
I mean, are we caught up in a day?
You guys fought some robots in the Lonely Tower.
But are we caught up to date, what they are? They're not.
Well, you guys don't not have a strong understanding of what robots are, but people have told you a bit about that, they're not human. They're creations,
We know they're made of a hard.
Edgar and John know a bit more because they've been reading. Edgar knows the most.
A couple chapters of the mechanic book, and I think we also read a little bit of the robotics book.
Yes. Okay. What I'll let you do though, Edgar, is go ahead and roll an intelligence roll and to see, we'll see how close you can get to your thought here.
I got nothing.
Yeah, we're gonna. That's a 2. So we're gonna say You're unsure of what, you know, would be like a weakness to these things. Like from what you've learned, like looking at these, it's not like obvious, kind of like, cause all their parts are on the inside and it's smooth on the outside. So it's like hard to find like a point of weakness that you could imagine affecting.
Show okay. a fake vaccinated card.
Okay. So my next turn, I'm going to do something similar.
Fuck,
I'm going to try something. I have an idea.
So
you Republican. No, I'm just kidding.
Hey, Daigle, do you have you don't have any like source of fire on you, do you? Since you're the closest to me.
What the fuck you mean I got a source of fire? I got nothing. Just got fucking stabbed in the neck by this fucking weird thing.
I'm right next to you, also.
So. Oh, you are. Fuck? Oh, shit.
Yeah, but I don't have a source of fire. I have a torch, but it's not lit.
Fuck. Well, that's what I'm looking for is somebody. Does anybody some have a source of flame here?
That would be Wilton. He has his torch on.
And his
plasma torch. Yeah. And I think it's about to be Wilton's turn, right?
Soon. Eventually.
Okay. I'm gonna try to climb up as the machine is going at Daigle. They're fucking tasseling. I'm going to try to climb up the back of it and then try to – the same location that Wilton Lenser bone snatch ripped open its head with the little thing. I'm going to try to take my cleaver to the same exact spot if that's going to fucking do anything.
So you're going to try to run past these other two robots towards Wilton?
No. I was saying the one that Daigle's fighting. So Wilton used his little thing to rip open the side of its head, right? Was it
not the one that Daigle's fighting?
Yeah, no. I was saying I wanted to take my cleaver and try to go at the same point that. Sorry, I'm having a hard time explaining this. So Wilton hit the side of that one's head. Was it like the right or left side of its head?
Yeah, but this is okay. So what I'm saying is like, if you want to get to the one that Wilton did that to, you have to run past two robots down the hallway.
No, I mean, I wanted to mimic what he did.
He was attacking an opportunity in the same spot is what he's saying.
Yeah, but okay. A robot. So the one that Daigle's fighting, I want to hit him at like,
sure.
So if Wilton melted one.
He's done attacking me, by the way. He's satisfied with penetrating me.
Penetration complete.
Basically what he said. Or I'm vaccinated now.
Okay, well what I'm saying was like
or poisoned. If Wilton, I don't
so, I got so you. Robot, I got you, Joe. Yeah, I got you, Edgar. So yeah, you want to try to attack like the same spot that like
the cleaver. The one that fucking penetrated Daigle.
Go for it.
Fuck him up.
So I just want to swing the fucking cleaver with all my Edgar might.
Gotcha.
God damn.
Well, that's definitely all the Edgar might.
Yeah.
Oh, bitch. Oh, that's a four. Yeah, so your cleaver just kind of, it deflects off the side. And yeah, you get the feeling that it's a little harder to get in there than it would be with whatever the hell Wilton has.
Oh, wait, no, he got me with the same thing?
No, you attacked and it didn't go through. That's what I was saying. It like kind of deflects off the side. It goes, pew! And you can tell that it's like harder to get through with something, you know, with this type of thing than it would be if you had the same thing Wilton had to cut through. Anything else you'd like to do?
Am I out of I'm out of attacks here, so...
You can move.
You can still move.
Shit. Who's the closest to Frank right now? His whatever body.
Probably.
That would be the second robot that's over top of him right now.
Okay. but nobody in our
party. I guess Daigle is technically the closest.
Poor Frank, man.
I guess can I
Peter's screaming, by the way. Peter's fucking screaming. He's just like
damn. Can I do something with an item that I have that's not really an attack?
Maybe. What do you want to do?
I wanted to pour the quart of oil that I have onto the ground and then scream for somebody to ignite it with flame. Like underneath,
you can dump your oil. You could definitely do that.
Okay, so I dump the oil underneath. It's tread. What do you call it? The little wheelie things that it's.
And which oil is this? Because I remember you've picked up like oil from several sources before.
This is the quart of oil that was given to me at the Lonely Tower.
Okay, gotcha. Okay.
Wasn't that like kerosene or some shit that we got from that guy?
I don't even remember.
It was flammable.
Yeah, it is.
It was, yeah.
Okay, well, I poured that at its treadmill feet. In my head, I'm thinking, you know, maybe there's rubber on its fucking tread. I don't know. I'm trying to slow it down. And then I yell out, somebody shoot its feet.
Gotcha. Okay. Yeah. So you do that. You manage to dump it out. Some of it gets on the treads and it's like all over the floor in front of it.
I'm hoping Peter fucking snaps out of it. Maybe he's got some form of fucking fire.
Wouldn't that be nice? So it's Daigle's turn.
Daigle.
Sorry. Give me.
Daigle, quit molesting that cat, bro. Sorry. Like...
Their penises are barbed.
I do some cat stuff.
You know, right. I've heard Nate do this
before. What?
You heard what?
Dude, beatboxes?
Beatbox.
Yeah, dude. What is that? I sell them at my work.
It's like a mixed drink.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Guys, I'm sorry. I did kind of miss a little bit.
It's your turn. Edgar Ford.
Yeah, I know it's my
ground. Matthew, you poured all oil on the ground.
Is it possible to?
And you're the closest to Frank.
You're in a tricky spot right now, and you're also like.
I'm trying to think what would be best. Is like I don't want to run over and try to help Frank, because I might slip.
Do you have like a gun or anything that can spark?
I have a gun, but I don't know. Like, does my character know that that works?
Well, I mean, it should.
You know, Daigle, fire comes out of it.
So, Daigle, I yelled. I poured a quart of oil, which is kerosene, I guess, onto the treads of the one that shot you up with the unknown drugs. I yelled, does anybody have any fire? I mean, you could possibly spark a bullet on that. If it's
how slow is he right now? Is he like Forrest Gump slow, or is he like Simple Jack slow right now?
I don't know what the right answer is. He's just regular Ben Stiller slow.
He's like Ben Stiller. He's been moving.
Yeah. so you right now. It's kind of like your head's swimming. Basically, how this is going to work out in the game is that you just get a -2 to all rolls while you're feeling this.
Okay.
Shoot it.
Boys.
So you feel a little off your game. Your head's swirling.
Everything is moving.
Hey, dude, don't
stop. And then he pulls out his gun.
I pull out my gun.
I guess I pull my gun and I...
Oh, fuck.
Is this what you fucking want me to do?
Shoot it, you dumb bastard. Just in slow motion and you're...
Let's go.
Shoot it, you dumb bastard.
You dumb... Motherfucker.
I'm loving this.
I shoot the oil.
Okay, roll for it.
Right. Getting a one. Ooh. Oh, nice.
Like my plus two, rolls. Right? Or is it plus one?
Yeah, yeah. It's your dex bonus.
Yeah, my dex. I think it's plus two. It might be just be a plus.
That's gonna
two.
Hit, man.
Well, because it just bounces out.
That's gonna hit. And for the record, viewers, listeners at home, guns aren't really good at starting fires, but rule of cool, this fucking happens.
I like it.
So the
Grand Theft Auto works on here.
Yeah. So the bullet hits the ground, bounces up at the treads, and a flame just goes up, and the unit begins warning, malfunction.
Sparking that metal, baby. Sparking the metal.
And yeah, the machine begins burning. Anything else you'd like to do?
But motherfucker.
good job, you dumb fuck.
Why the hell are you guys talking like that?
It's in his perspective. I'm just going.
I know. Yeah. My thought is he's talking like that, and you're just mimicking him to try to speak.
Motherfucker.
Anything else you'd like to do?
I think that'll do it.
It's Peter's turn.
He better not be picking pipes of peppers.
You can see that his tail is just like flicking like this, and it must mean panic. It's like it just keeps flicking to the left over and over again. It's like twitching. Peter, he's reaching around and he's like looking through his pockets, and he gets into one of his pockets and he pulls out a flare and he strikes it on the ground
and it goes woo!
And lights up a fire, and he's just like holding it out in front of him, and he sees Wilton by the he sees Frank on the ground now. He goes and he just starts like trying to shove the machine off of Frank.
Come on, Peter.
Griffin. But he doesn't seem to be making any headway. The robot he's shoving says, "Thank you for submission." And oh my god, and it stabs him in the neck.
Jesus.
Peter, no.
We needed
Peter. Shit.
Oh fuck. And Peter goes out, dude. Peter like wobbles back and he falls against the wall, and you can see his tail still flicking, and it's flicking gentler and gentler as his head slumps forward, and he just kind of falls into his own lap.
RP Pete and Peter
Cottontail. Peter!
Peter Cottontail.
Peter Cottontail.
Mechanical tail.
Peter Rat Tail.
Peter Rat Tail. And that was
trailer park.
And then yeah, the robot that's on top of Frank, you can see the top half of it like turns both ways, like looks both and it turns around like in place, like grinding Frank.
Oh god.
And then starts heading over towards Edgar and Daigle and John.
Shit.
Let's see how much.
Fuck!
Okay.
Is this something, by the way, can I ask, is this something that's going to subdue me for the remainder of the fight, or can I roll a constitution against it? Is it not crazy bad, or is it something that's kind of going to make me woozy for a little bit?
So, I'll just tell you it lasts a discrete number of turns, and I'm not going to tell you how many.
Okay. Cool.
Okay. So yeah, now it's Wilton and then Robo 4 is what his name is on the paper. So okay, Robo versus Wilton. It is showering sparks on top of you, and like you can see like your reflection in its steely frame, like the sparks like flashing in your eyes, and it says malfunction imminent. Please submit for more. And it just like it does kind of like a lazy swing of like the needles towards you, and does a 16 hit you?
I have a 16 for my AC.
Oh, that's gonna hit then.
Dang.
Damn it.
All right, that's gonna do 2 points of damage, and roll a constitution save, my friend.
North.
Oh shit.
Constitution.
Plus two. 16. Okay, that's actually gonna make it, dude. You managed to keep your consciousness. Yeah. But again, Nick, just like mentioned with Daigle, things begin to slow down. It looks like the sparks are coming more slowly out. It's like you're seeing like streamers or trails behind each of the sparks as they fly out of the robot in front of you now. And it's Frank's turn.
Frank's intestines are on the ground. He tries to roll them back up in his abdomen.
There's no movement from Frank. It's Wilton's turn.
Oh, Wilton.
Okay. Oh, my God.
So this thing's basically shut down, yeah?
It's shutting down. It's still moving. Oh, and it says,
thank you.
Can I just push that?
And it spits out only one lemon drop. Dunk.
Can I just push that one out of the way and go?
The lemon drop?
No, the robot. Because there's another one pushing behind it, right?
Okay. Yeah, you're gonna shove past it.
Yeah, so I want to shove that one out of the way. Take my flail and just hit it as hard as I can against one of its tire or one of its arms, I guess.
Oh, the one that's going towards Daigle and John and them?
I thought there was two coming towards me. I thought there was another one pushing up behind it. I might be wrong.
Oh, there is. There's that one coming through the doorway. You want to attack that one?
Yeah, the other one that's coming towards me.
Gotcha. All right, go for it. Yeah, you're able to easily move past the malfunctioning robot. 8+.
Nothing. 8+2.
I think you have higher modifiers because you're like proficient with this weapon. So it should be +2 plus your proficiency bonus.
Oh,
Sorry.
I forgot about proficiency stuff. Playo is +1. Hold on, give me 1 second. Let me read it. Real quick.
Probably, yeah. Yeah.
+6 to hit.
Love you.
It says flail +6 to hit with the 1d8 +3.
So hold on, are you a flail expert instead of a bow expert now?
Yeah,
he's got
muscle memory, I assume.
See, yeah. I thought maybe he would get back his bowmanship, but that's actually kind of cool. I like that.
Yeah, he's kind of like a fighter now.
Nice.
Yeah, so I guess you guys are now seeing him pull out his weapon probably for the first time. So he pulls out this weapon, and it's just like it's a handle. It's like a metal handle with a chain coming off of it. And then at the end is this kind of like cut crystal.
Like a piece of like obsidian or something?
Yeah, yeah. It looks cool. It actually does look like a piece of obsidian.
Dope.
And it's like cut into some kind of like how some flails are ribbed. It's kind of cut into those ribs.
So is it like more sharp than it is blunt? I'm sorry. I'm just thinking about it.
Yeah, it's mostly blunt.
Okay. Dope.
Wicked. So
edges give fucking wicked burns or wicked bruises.
That's a 14. Unfortunately, that's going to miss though.
And dude, you brandished the weapon and missed. Weapon missed.
Yeah, you get a second attack though, I believe.
Oh yeah.
As a fizzy.
Better hit him as Dr. Robot.
Oh, he gets one less than last time. That'll also miss. That'll miss more.
I don't know.
Okay. And that will be okay.
Did you carry the two?
I did.
You whisked it, and it slightly missed your whiskers, and you.
So the one that originally stabbed Daigle in the neck is now going for John.
Damn.
That's going to be a big miss.
Is that the one we burned that went haywire?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, it's burning and it's saying malfunction imminent. Please submit. And it spins around and it misses dramatically, just like flailing its arms past John. He's easily able to get out of the way, and it's John's turn.
Wacky inflatable tube man.
okay. This is gonna sound weird. I want to take my backpack and bedroll and put it on my chest and try to absorb the needles into that bag.
Into your bedroll?
Yeah.
Okay.
Interesting. Yeah. It's trying to do is vaccinate me. I want to try this.
Okay.
Fuck. Dude, what the fuck is up with these rolls?
What hits you in the dick?
Well, for that, I don't think you really have to do an attack. So I'll do a roll because it's flailing its arms around you, right? Okay. Yeah, so that plus your attack would be like a plus 6, 11. Dude, yeah. Okay. So you're able to put up your bag in the way, and it shoves its arm, and three needles go into your sleeping bag.
Okay.
And, I mean, you can't really tell what happened with it, but it does go into the bag. And after that happens, it doesn't respond. It doesn't say anything.
Shit. Okay.
Anything else?
I mean, if I can make an attack, then I'm going to try to fucking punch this thing away from me or try to, like... If the arm is still in the bag, try to fucking hit it at the joint with my hand or gauntlet.
All right. Go for it. Yuki. It's okay.
What the fuck?
Oh, no. It's a 3. That's going to be a 9 altogether or more, but still not enough. And that's going to miss.
I mean, do I still get my second hit? Because I'll try it again.
No, because you took the action with the bag. Yeah, okay, so I think okie dokie.
God damn.
This would be the next robot. It's trying to shove past you, John, to get to Edgar.
Bring him up.
You want me to strength check it or?
Yeah, so as it goes, it's going out of range of Wilton, so Wilton gets an attack of opportunity.
Oh, right now?
Dude, yeah. Flail your
right now and only now.
I attack it.
With your flail?
How, man? Like, why is he getting the only good roll?
That's gonna hit. Well, he's already missed. So, I mean, he missed his first attack. Okay, roll your damage. 1d8 plus 3, I believe. Yes. Oh, boy. 5 damage? Okay. 5 damage. Wicked. And it is Edgar's turn. Oh, wait, no, it's attacking Edgar. So, yeah, it goes across. I guess it actually goes.
Balance?
It goes past Daigle, too. So, Daigle also gets an attack of opportunity.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Do you want me to roll d20?
Yes. Roll an attack, baby.
There you go. 17.
What are you attacking with, by the way?
With my daggers. It's my thing that I have out.
Daggers.
Gotcha. Yeah, so one dagger strike. Go ahead and roll damage.
Oh, shit. And I got a 1+, right? Sorry, level. Ooh, I have...
You have a lot of plus.
Oh, yeah. A lot of plus. Okay.
You a plus-size individual right now.
Mm-hmm. Oh, nice.
Mm-hmm, girl.
That's my shit. All the... 1d3? Or d4, I mean. Sorry.
Along with it, Lizzo.
That's my shit. All the girl. I ain't no holler back, girl.
Yeah, it's 3 plus. I forget what your bonus is, but I think it's like 5 or something like that. I don't, what is it? Yeah,
oh, so he doesn't
get
damage, dude.
Oh, dude, I have a plus 8 to hit.
What's your
bonus
for damage?
Is that, but I don't know.
That sounds right.
I put in quotations, but I also have masterwork daggers. So that's,
that gives you plus one.
Yeah, I think that's including my plus one.
I think so. I think it would be plus 7 without it. But okay. Yeah. Dude, whack. That's going to hit. Okay. And what are your bonuses to damage? Because it's like quite a few things.
I think he has the biggest bonus out of all of us to damage.
Yeah.
Like it is, it's pretty extreme.
I want to say it's plus 5, but I just don't know because I can't see your shit.
Oh, yeah, plus 5. That's it's plus 5. Yeah.
It's changed.
Yeah, for the ninth mastery. Because,
I appreciate what y'all are doing. Plus 5. Edgar right now.
I tried outsmart the robots and it didn't work.
So you stab it. So you stab it and you manage to stab it like it goes through like its tube arms. And you can see that the arm like kind of twitches and like kind of like falls down to the side. And you can see like it keeps trying to like come back up, but it's not
take
able to.
Take down
like,
your fucking puppet! And I fucking plunge into it. Take down your fucking puppet!
And you can hear it say, engineer required, engineer required. And it turns towards you, Daigle, and it says, oh, fuck. Thought I had some of these written down.
You forgot your lemon drops.
Oh no!
You were a good girl.
Casey, are you pulling clean feet or did your phone just die?
Here's a sticker. Yeah,
my phone died.
Okay, cool. Okay. You're still in though. Okay.
Casey's actually trying to masturbate. He got a little hot and heavy. Mike, are those good? Because I have them
at my work. They're amazing. It's alcoholic.
They're less than $4 at my work.
Here it is. So it turns
it's
towards you.
Kool-Aid, dude.
I have a hell of different flavors.
It turns towards you and it says the patient 385 is AWOL. Patient 385.
Oh, shit. Oh, I think I'm going to try something.
I'm thinking about something too.
Edgar's turn.
Can I yell at Edgar?
Is the one rushing?
Find engineer! Somebody find engineer! That's the motherfucker that's responsible for this! That's the marionette! That's the motherfucker who control these bastards!
Can I do an action? Can I do a narrative action before an actual physical one? Or is that gonna...
Well, I don't know. Maybe. What are you thinking?
Are you thinking, Lincoln?
The one that was rushing at me that had the that Daigle and both Daigle and Wilton had the attack of opportunity. Is that one rushing at me right now? Still or
no? It's turned on Daigle basically.
Oh, okay.
It was so coming towards.
I want to yell at the one that turned on Daigle and be like, 001 authorization clearance for all personnel. I don't know.
Honestly, I was thinking the same thing, Joseph. So,
okay, let's do a percentile.
My thing was going to be engineer 001 reporting for duty. Please stand by or some shit like that. Okay,
here's how it's going to go, Joe. This is pretty slim chances. So what you're looking at is you have to give me a number between 1 and 4, right? You name a number between 1 and 4, and we'll see if it corresponds with the percentile range.
3. Yeah.
3. No. Nothing happens.
So can I still do an
authorization denied.
You son of a bitch. can I still do it like a physical thing then?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay. Yeah,
that was just you talking, so yeah.
Okay, so is distilled alcohol flammable, right?
It is. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to take that makeshift net that was never used on a Nasher and soak it in distilled alcohol. Mm. Yeah, we never used it on the Nasher.
No. I know.
if you remember the little tidbit. No, I know.
Oh, I remember. I remember taking a lot of hits because you decided not to throw a goddamn net.
Hey, look, we all make mistakes, okay? Anyways, so I take this net... Okay, the makeshift net, and I douse it in my distilled alcohol, and I throw it like closest to its feet and mid-body as possible, and then I turn around after doing it and then point at it and then look at Daigle, and I go, Daigle, look, hit the honeycombs to the little hexagon shapes in the net, trying to get his little fucked up... His little drugged out brain to fucking pay attention. Hit the honeycombs with the gun.
Thank you.
I don't know if I got to roll for that.
You're welcome.
No, to just point that out to him. Yeah, is that all you're gonna do?
Yeah, throw the distilled alcohol net.
Okay, so now that you're throwing this at range instead of just like pouring it right in front of you, go ahead and roll an attack for that because you're throwing it.
Okay.
Hell that's definitely going to hit with your bonuses for sure. Yeah.
Daigle, look, hit the honeycombs. And I'm fucking pointing at the fucking hexagon.
Hit the honeycombs, Daigle, with your boom boom stick. Jackass.
And it is Daigle's turn now.
Daigle, where you at? You didn't hear me?
He's playing with cats.
Sorry.
Dude, you can play with cat pussies. Nah, dude, those cat pussies ain't going nowhere. Those cussies ain't going nowhere.
Cussies.
Anyways, Matthew, so Daigle, I soaked the makeshift net that was supposed to be used for Nashers with distilled alcohol, and I threw it on the body, and then I talked to you in a slow motion thing. It's like, hit the honeycombs with your boom boom stick, dumbass.
The most intelligent guy here is Connor Gunn. Like he's read the most of the engineering and the robotics books. He's like boom boom stick.
Is that just super condescending?
I'm sorry.
I shoot.
No, it is condescending because Daigle.
I fire another shot.
Daigle fire around right now.
Boom. Okay. Do a roll. Do an attack roll.
Hit that Grand Theft Auto fire.
That goosh.
Come on.
At least it wasn't a one.
Plus two. 11.
Yeah, you shoot Edgar right in the head. No, I'm just kidding.
Edgar's dead. His brain pours out of his head. And all he says is, mashed potatoes.
But yeah, that is going to miss. Anything else you'd like to do?
Do I still get another shot?
You can attack with the dagger again this turn, I think.
Oh, can I run and just do my left? Can I? Is that okay? Can I do that? Can I plunge my other dagger?
Mm-hmm.
Is that net still connected?
Yeah, the net's on him.
This motherfucker.
Okay, Wicked, that's going to hit. Roll for damage. Yeah, it's a 19. 19 plus a lot.
Mm-hmm.
That's another 8 damage.
I was hoping if that didn't work, the netting would get caught in his threads.
Bitch!
It's Peter's turn. Okay. Oh, I forgot. He's knocked the fuck out.
He's flopping like a fish on the floor.
Yeah.
Ah, man. Peter.
Peter, balls. Pumpkin eater. Flopping on the floor.
Okay, the other robot that is by, like, you guys in Daigle, it goes, it sees like Daigle has been, so like it's pointed over towards Daigle. It sees that he's been like vaccinated and that he's like attacking the robots, and it goes towards him and it puts out its arms and it says, patient 385, come with me. And it like reaches out its arms to like just grab you. All will be well. Please relax. You are safe.
As a round? Oh, well, it's not really damage, huh?
No.
Does it grab me, or can I try to dodge, or is it...
Oh, well, here, let me see, actually. So I should roll that. It's going to be a 19?
Ooh, probably not. Should I roll against it?
To dodge, yeah, go ahead.
Very unlikely. Oh, shit.
Okay, so Dave, you get wrapped up.
It's like a hug.
Oh, by the way, there's a lit torch on the ground in Peter's hand, if you guys remember.
Is it a cool looking torch?
Or a flare. Or is it on fire? It's a flare.
It's lit.
Yeah, I mentioned that he lit it earlier before he got knocked out. So that's still there. And the robo that has like run over, this is the one that's over by Wilton. Now I'm getting confused. No, this is the robot with the net on it. Yeah. Okay. This is not the burning one. You're being held by the burning one, Dago. I just realized.
Oh, shit.
The
oh,
burning shit. Malfunctioning one is holding you, and you can feel the heat, like, coming towards your legs as, like, this Fuck. Thing is, like, starting to go up in flames.
Fuck, it's hot! It's fucking hot! Somebody fucking save me! Somebody fucking save me! Help!
Well, okay, so yeah, the one with the net, it's over by Edgar. So it gets covered with the net, and it starts like streaming towards Edgar. And
would the net get caught in its treading, or no? Probably not, because it's like tank.
Well, you threw it on the Let's top see. Half of it.
No, I threw it from the treads to the highest point I could from its. I made sure to make that a point. I start from the bottom, like kind of.
Now you're here.
Is that so? That's what you did. So you threw it towards the bottom then.
Yeah, towards the bottom, as high up as I could from the bottom up.
Let's see. All right. Well, in that case, the netting, he rolls forward, and the netting kind of just gets like pulled down.
Okay. Is it stuck in his treads or no?
So wait,
You're held by a different one. There's like four of these things. They're all four of them are still up. You're held by a different one. By a burning one. Okay, yeah. So it goes down underneath its treads. It doesn't seem like if it is caught up in the treads, it doesn't seem like it's slowing him down.
Okay, I just want to make sure it's still attached to him.
Yeah, I think it's still on his treads though. And it gets a nat 20 to stab you in the neck.
Son of a bitch. You.
Robot gets a +5 experience.
Well, he's gonna be a washing machine someday. Just watch.
You get a plus. I'm gonna be a real doctor robot. So you get a plus. You take a well, you take plus a five robot, damage. You take 5 damage. Roll a Constitution roll save. Save.
Fingers crossed.
Oh,
19. Fuck yeah,
Edgar, Big Dick Nolum.
Dude, well, I mean, if you think about it, I feel like given to drug abuse as a child, this man has a high tolerance to it.
Oh, my God. I just realized something, too. Okay, so.
Oh, I do, don't I?
As this fucking soporific hits your bloodstream and you're able to, like, you know, fight back against it, the feeling of the drugs in your veins is kind of like returning home and being, like, hugged by your mother. And you feel like you actually feel bright and jolly and not slow. And it feels like therapy almost. It feels like some of the hardships and stuff that you've experienced recently that have been so difficult and people you've seen die or whatever. Like some of that's beginning to melt away a little.
Artificial happiness.
Oh shit. My insanity. Am I going to lose a point in that or?
Depending on how this battle turns out, I think so.
Oh, wow. That's awesome. That's so fucking cool.
Because that is a feature of your class. Yeah.
He's getting therapy through drug manipulation. That's dope.
Yeah. And then the robot, like, so now you're just, there's like this radiating kind of like, it's like a gold glow in this room. Every source of light kind of has like a goldish halo around it now. And then from the golden light of this robot in front of you, you just hear, thank you. Tink, tink. As two lemon drops fall in front of you.
That's fucking great.
Euphoria from Malphoria addicts.
You guys hear an explosion. As the robot that was hit with the fusion cutter just completely detonates down the side of the hall, there is a white gas that's beginning to like emit into the room, or a smoke, white smoke or gas or something is like emanating from like this robot, M Night Shyamalaning from this robot, like, and it's not Frank's turn, it's Wilton's turn. There we go,
Frank on the ground, bruv. It's Frank's turn. Yeah. He lays there.
You actually can see now, Wilton, because of the light of the torch that is in Peter's hand, you can see that Frank is indeed breathing, but one of his feet is turned backwards. It's like it's like facing the opposite direction it's supposed to.
Can I go to him?
Yes.
I run over to him.
All right, you don't have to run very far.
You smack him in the face.
He takes a step.
I smack him in the face and say, "Wake up, motherfucker. You got shit to do. Get up, you lazy stack of shit."
Yeah, he does not wake up.
Can I smack him harder?
Yeah.
I'm going to smack him harder.
All right, use your second attack to smack him harder. Go ahead and roll for this one. D20.
You little...
I mean, yeah, you're going to hit anyway. Roll D4. Smack the shit out of him. See if this helps.
Roll damage.
2 plus your 2 strength, I believe. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Well, he takes 4 more damage.
Oh, my God. Wilson, you savage.
And he does not wake up. You see that you're like your mouth claws, like, you know, they scrape his face a little bit. You can see that he's like bleeding and he's just completely unconscious.
God damn. That's upsetting.
Damn you, Frank. Can I just pick him up then?
Yes. You try. Use his strength. Nice. Yeah. Okay, so you're able to sling him over your shoulder, and as he swings over your shoulder, his gun is like on his rifle is like on a strap around his arm, and you feel it flick around and kind of just like tap the back of your elbow, and he's like over your shoulder now. And oh yeah, this guy's gone. This is not
the flame. See the wizard.
And you see the robot that's like nearest to you, it like the one with the crippled arm, who has like a single arm because Daigle like cut the other one. It turns towards you and it says, "Thank you, patient 387. Please take patient 383 to the med bay."
Will do.
Which way do you head with him?
To the rest of the guys.
That is not towards the med bay. Please, turn around. Patient 387.
I head towards the med bay.
Okay, you head towards the med bay, and it says, immediate help required. Immediate help required. And the other robot that is also damaged but not on fire, the one that's actually like that just stabbed Edgar, just turns around and begins going away. And the other one that's on fire with Daigle, they all three begin heading into the med bay.
Oh, fuck.
So Wilton's in the front, and now the three robots are like coming behind you in a fucking line, and all of you are funneling into the med bay now. As you're,
are we out of combat now, or are we still in combat?
Okay, so if you want to keep attacking, then you would have to stay in combat. But if you guys are taking this as a signal to stop fighting, then you can.
I want to attack.
I want to attack again because I had a good little thing.
Yeah, I'm gonna stop.
Well, can I, like, I don't know, because, like, turn-based is different in combat, right? Can I, like, run towards Frankie?
Yeah, well, the next person's turn is John.
Okay. I'm going to stop and try to slip into the med bay without, like, I'm gonna like, follow behind them, but out of range, and just try to slip into the med bay, and I want to do a check to see if there's, like, a power for the robots.
Okay. All right, yeah, go ahead and roll it.
14. And then I don't have a perception bonus, but my intelligence is +2.
All right. So looking in this room, you can see that like the front half of the room is still lit, but it goes way back. There's a huge med bay. There's a bunch of these tables, and the tables have like these lights arranged above them. Some of them are completely spotless, the ones that are like in this first lit section. But as you go further back into the room, the tables and the lights hanging over them are kind of like covered in cobwebs. Some of them even have corpses like laying in the beds that have been like... There's almost nothing left of them. They're basically mummified.
Okay.
And then on the sides of the room, you can see that there are these pods. And there's a bunch of broken pods the further you go into the room. And you can see that there are the four lit pods. And each of those has, like, a control panel with some displays on it. And it looks like those probably correspond to these, you know, robots.
I'd like to go to the control panel, but I want to wait and see if they... Because I'm assuming they're going to fix Frank.
Mm-hmm.
And fix his leg so and stuff.
You actually see there's three control panels here that are lit, and then there's one of them that is lit, but the light is red.
Okay, yeah. So context clues. Okay, cool. So I'm going to go to the three other course. I'm going to go in a good spot where I can get to either one of the three corresponding things and wait to see if they fix Frank. Ready to turn them off. Can I look at one of the panels first so I can get a see if there's an off button pretty much?
Yeah, you can start getting a look at the panel and go ahead and roll an intelligence check.
And then my intelligence is +2. Okay. So 11.
It doesn't look like there's a clear shutoff, but you do see, like, I guess you guys have done your reading for today, so you can read this language, but you can see the word program settings.
Okay.
Looks like there's, like, a selection. You might have to go through some menus. All right. This is the burning robo with Daigle in his hands. So Daigle, you can try to like this robot's still just holding you, and you take 3 points of fire damage as the flames begin licking up your pants. Daigle?
Oh shit, my bad, my mic wasn't on. Are they retreating right now afterwards or?
I'd like
to it's still holding you in its arms. They're moving into this room, but it is on fire and it is holding you and it's like bringing you towards a table, essentially.
Let me go. I fucking comply. I comply. Let me go. Let me go.
Can I just
say to the robot? Malfunction. Malfunction. Engineer required.
Fuck engineer! Fuck that man!
I take a dagger and I try to like plunge it into its face, or well the top part of it, I guess. But I understand what would have been the brain if it was.
So now your arms are kind of pinned against your sides. What you could you can try to escape can though. You can do a dex roll to try to start wriggling.
I guess try to like freaking worm my way out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you get one attempt right now because he's just trying to move you across the room, and then you can try again when you get to your turn.
All right. Cool. Oh, there we go.
Oh, nice. That's +1, 17.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
Oh, I got +2. I think.
Oh, 18. Wicked. Okay, so yeah, you managed to wriggle free of the arms. As you do, it just goes error, malfunction, and you can see that its arms actually just keep tightening around its own body until they're just like completely wrapped around, and you can hear the clicking of the little needles in its fingers as they kind of like twitch against its middle frame.
Oh my god, dude!
Can I intervene? Probably not.
I almost got Iron Maidened.
And it's Edgar's turn.
I start walking up with jaded eyes with a big ass smile on my face to the one that's doing that, the Daigle. And then I say, Mama, where are you going, Mama? Don't leave me. Please, Mama, not again. I promise I'll be good. And I pull out the phosphoric acid vial. Don't leave, Mama. Please. Please, oh, I got your medicine right here. Please, don't leave, Mama. I'm a good boy. I'm a good boy. And I throw the phosphoric acid at the one that's holding Daigle. Yeah.
Okay, the one that was holding Daigle?
Yeah.
Okay, wicked. Yeah, roll for the attack.
18.
Oh, wow. That's definitely a hit. That's 18 plus a lot. So,
are you feeling better, Mama? I have tears rolling down my eyes and a very fucking... Even though I have large-ass pupils, it's just like I'm not seeing what's in front of me. Just smiling, crying. Do you feel better now?
Roll for damage.
Is that the... is that the... Which one is that one? I forget.
Did you said you threw a phosphoric...
One? Yeah, phosphoric acid shit.
Yeah, 2d4 plus your intelligence, I believe.
2d4, okay. Ooh, my intelligence, plus 3.
All right. Yeah, so luckily, Daigle wasn't in its arms because that thing, it just explodes. And, like... its treads, they split across the bottom, a bunch of oil pours on the floor, and there's a big puddle of fire now, and like one of the tables goes up in flames, and then you can see that like one of the three remaining like lit bays that is not red, it turns red. Boom. The one that John's standing at right now, actually, like it goes red, and you can see the little screen that you were looking at, it says system override.
I was gonna say, god damn it, where's the I was gonna say something and I can't remember where the nope, never mind, I got it. One second, sorry. Okay, I started is it a Silamana? A Silamana?
Yes,
a Silamana. It's Edgar just starts laughing at the explosion. Silamana, I'm coming. I promise I'm going to make it better.
Oh my god.
Everything is going to be better. And then Edgar just goes down to his into a fetal position, crying with his eyes wide open, bloodshot. It's going to be okay. Everything's going to be better.
Dude. To the broken robot or where?
Yeah, no, in front of the broken robot. You said it exploded. He's just doing that, like grabbing his hair in a fetal position, standing fetal position, like squatting, elbows to knees, just bloodshot eyes, laughing and crying at the same time.
Oh my god, it's a healing moment.
Yeah.
But yeah, okay. You begin to feel the catharsis of your actions as you feel as if maybe you've healed. I don't know how to say that.
Where'd my pen go? Oh,
probably up your ass with that last thing you did.
Yeah, I'm really jerking myself off with this one.
Yeah, try not to jerk yourself off too hard. Wait till I get there. I'll be there.
It's Daigle's turn.
So will Nate, to be honest.
Yeah, you guys could be out of combat too, because the other two robots are just moving towards the table with Wilton, and one of them has the broken arm, but it's like it's pointing and says, place patient 383 upon the table, please.
I run over the Frank. Frank!
Frank is in Wilton's arm.
Come on.
I'm holding
him. You're right. I like tap his shoulder while Wilton's holding him. You're right. Right, come on.
There's no response.
Fuck.
I just throw him on the table.
All right. He flops down, and you can see that there's just like there's tread marks over like his arms, like there's patches of fur that have been ripped off from being run over. One of his feet, his left foot is just turned completely backwards. completely turned in the wrong direction.
I look at these the robots and I say, "Fix them!" Like thinking they are conscious. Fix them or I fucking got ya.
Commencing procedure. And you can see the two. They go over to their to their like pods that are in the wall. And you can see that they stick their hands into these two holes in the wall, and you see that there is like these metal things being pumped into the tubes inside of their arms. And when they pull out, like they have their hands, and you can see that there's like each hand is now split into like a double set of hands. And there's like this central cavity in the center. And when they go back over to the table, you can see that they like move their wrists and the tools begin to like come out. And that each of their hands is holding like two tools as they begin to like perform an operation on his leg.
This is so cool. This is so fucking cool.
Yep. So they start by like turning his leg around. Like, so while all this is going on, you guys are free to do as you would. But let me just describe what's going on here.
Okay.
So yeah, they begin. They start by like turning his foot all the way around. You see one of them like actually administers a bit more sedative. Another one starts withdrawing a blood sample and like sets an IV up next to him. The IV actually just like comes out of its own body, like the cable in the bag, and it sets it up. And the light comes on, like on the table where he's laying down. And yeah, the two robots just begin to go to work as they move around both sides of him. And they begin to apply ointments to the patches where his fur has been torn, and they begin mending his leg.
I'd like to go through the system options and see if I can find a shutoff, just so I know where it's at.
Oh, sure. Yeah. So you go to one of the other bays that is not currently displaying red with system override. And go ahead. Do an intelligence, y'all.
And plus two.
Wow. 18. That's mad wicked smart, John Gilmore.
Oh,
that's an 18. Okay. Yeah. So you realized after a second of like looking at these like labels on there that like, you know, when you touch them, it goes to like different screens.
Cool.
And yeah, you click through a few and you see one screen says maintenance schedule and it says shutdown Y/N.
Okay. I want to do this. I want to bring up that screen on all three computers.
Okay,
and just,
cool.
And just wait. Also, I got to say, are you from the East Coast?
What?
Are you from the East Coast?
Saying wicked? No, he's
mad wicked instead of hella.
Mad wicked.
Well, I say hella too.
I know, but like, are you from the East Coast?
Well, a lot of my family is. I didn't really live there myself. Yeah.
I have family from the East Coast, and we had this argument where they made fun of me for saying hella, and I was like, what do you say? They would say, we say mad. I was like, well, that's fucking stupid.
Mad.
To be fair, I say
this family was from New Jersey, so
mad is, it's funny because mad is more, it's also like, European slang too.
West, yeah, it's old. That's why it's there. It's mad, one of the original colonies, you know?
Only everybody else says like mad and wicked.
Yeah, no, Mike, I was going to say, Mike,
if you go to Europe, people say mad a lot too.
And no, I heard Theo Vaughn said hello before, and I was like, wait, what the fuck, dude?
No, dude, it's making its way over. Like, hella's spreading.
No, but Mike, and mad is too. People say mad annoying over here, mad this and mad that a lot.
They do.
They go say mad something. Annoying. Or that's
we've got to not get too far in the weeds here, guys, though, because we're gonna end up losing the thread.
Casey, are you still alive?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's just jerk off writing his rap for his next rap battle.
Okay. Don't
remember, put spaghetti in there.
Okay, so I just set up the computers with the override commands ready to go.
All right, let's go.
All right, what are you guys doing here? Oh, Peter's still slumped in the hallway, by the way.
Can I
with the flare in his hand.
Can I the flare's still active, right?
Yes.
Can I do a very NPC move?
Yes.
I want to put myself on a free range. I lift myself from the fetal position, still with tears in my eyes, smiling, even though I'm by myself, and I'm like, run. And then I just take off, and I, on a maddening fucking quest, I'm just looking for things to make my blueprints come to life. So I'm just on a scavenging hunt.
Okay, yeah, you begin running through there and searching for things. Go ahead and do a perception check. Okay, or do an intelligence check, because there's all kinds of fucking supplies in here. So just do a check, you know.
Yeah, in the most passive way, I'm not going in the okay.
So. And I look at Wilton and his rat eyes. What the fuck's going into him?
20, oh, baby.
That's Jesus. A 20, Noam.
Oh, and that's extra 5, right?
Yeah, it's 5 XP for you. Dude, that is like, this is like the third 20 you've got for doing searches.
Yeah, I was about to say, how are you really searching this good, you motherfucker? Your perception's off the charts.
Edgar's going on a mad scientist run now. Like,
And you're just like, I see everything.
Yeah, no, Edgar's enlightened now. That's why he's just like, run. And they just, and by the way, that's a nod to Bray Wyatt, the late Bray Wyatt, by the way, RIP.
Died of a heart attack.
Run. No, he died. Well, he died of a heart disease, actually. Run. And he was only a couple years. I think he might have been 35 at most.
He would have lived a couple years longer if he didn't eat McDonald's every day of his life.
Hey, okay. that man.
In your inspired hunt through this room, you managed to find like all the remaining pieces that you need to create your homunculus.
Yeah, as I'm mumbling, I'm like,
it takes you a while. So like while this surgery is going on and while your friends are doing whatever the hell they're doing, you over a period of time, you manage to find all the things you need.
I'm just mumbling as I'm doing it, like just echoes down the hall, synthetic organic. I'm just running through it, just laughing and just fucking, just nonsense.
If I was paying attention to you, I'd be very uneasy.
Yeah, I look at John, this boy's going fucking mad.
So add to your inventory. Just put in your inventory homunculus ingredients and surgical kit. Mad wicked pisser.
Mad wicked hella nice. Get all three in there, man.
Yeah, damn, that's hella mad.
You're a multicultural man. No.
I am.
Menvar be damned.
Today, Monday. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So what is it? What is everybody doing at this time? Frank is out. Peter's out and still laying on the ground with. I think Daigle was saying something about going to Peter. Was that true or no?
Yeah. I get that.
Casey, you still there?
Yeah.
Peter.
Okay.
Peter. Wake up. Wake up, lad. You're a fighter. You can't die like this. Wake up, Peter. Wake up, man. I slap him a couple times across the face.
Yeah, he doesn't wake up. Bam, bam. Yeah, you slap him and his like limp body just moves left and right and he slumps over on top of the torch.
Can I run in the med bay, like, or like in the room that they're doing the thing in? I'll put a man down! You fucking puppets, go there and grab him! Revive them on! Come on!
Revive the man. Okay, so yeah, you see one of the robots, like, it's like in the middle of the surgery, and it turns back over and it says, patient 384, please bring him to table 2.
Can I run out there and grab him and try to move him over?
Yeah. You can
fight, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Peter's not too heavy. He's a tall guy, but he's real thin.
What about that thick, girthy tail he's got?
Oh, he does have that mechanical tail. That's probably pretty heavy. But yeah. Okay. Roll. Roll a thing.
All right.
Roll a thing.
Jordan, buddy, give me a fucking hand here.
It's almost as if you're getting lazy as a DM right now.
I asked John for help.
My phone died. John. Hold on.
Okay.
Why didn't you give me a fucking hand here?
I ain't fucking moving. I don't know when these robots are going to change. I got to be ready. You carry that fucker himself.
Take I have a minus
fucking,
one to
take
strength.
Take the fucking tail off him if you need to. It's not like it's real anyways.
Yeah, you know, I wasn't really big into arts and crafts, so there's no fucking way I can remove this fucking tail.
Okay, it's just a couple belts. You can get over it. I need to stay here at the fucking computers.
I whisper to Peter, sounds like fucking lazy to me.
I heard that, fucker. I'm not lazy. I'm trying to save our lives. Did.
Save whose lives here? Peter's fucking lady. Our lives. He's about ready to pass over. You're going to sit there for what?
He had a panic attack.
This fucking man is Frank, cold as steel.
My fucking foot is backwards. I think fuck Peter's going to be fine.
John, he was a dick. He was a fucking dick. I mean, it's, who cares if he passes over? Fuck that guy.
Frank or Peter?
Frank.
Yeah, but his foot's backwards. He's on the table for a reason.
Yeah, who cares if he walks another day in his life?
Take Peter.
Fuck that man.
Take Peter and lean him up against the wall. He'll be fine.
I'm trying.
I tried to pick up Peter with 11 because I have minus one.
Okay, yeah, you wrestle him up and basically you're dragging him.
I'm sorry, Peter. You're no worse for wear, so we should be fine.
His metal tail is just like scraping on the floor.
I try to like hoist them up into the thing.
Yeah, Wilton, what do you do while you're seeing all this happen? You're just watching, bro. What the fuck?
It's, hey, look at him go. Now, can I look around for supplies and shit, too?
Yeah, loot. What are you looking just for? Loot. That's so know. Fucking funny.
Makes sense for a rat to scavenge.
Yeah.
Oh, shut the fuck up, Edgar. You're scavenging first.
Yeah, go ahead and roll. Go ahead and do a, you know, get perceptive, dog. Yeah, get them beady alive. Little eyes going.
Oh. You know you're in a room. Go back to episode one. Wesley, if you're listening to the unedited thing, that's for you.
Phantom Menace.
Yeah. Okay, so... Yeah, that's plus four, though, right? It's 11?
Yeah.
Highs or lows?
We'll do lows.
Okay. You find one fuel cell.
Nice.
So you're looking through, you're seeing all this equipment, and you can't really make heads or tails of this stuff because, like, you don't really have any medical knowledge. So, like, looking at all these things, you're looking at, like, vials and containers and, like, not really pouches. Everything's held in kind of, like, these little, like, steel bins, like canisters. And then there's, like, totes and there's, like, all kinds. Yeah, there's just a ton of stuff you don't really understand, but you do happen across a fuel cell.
Nice.
You're like, oh, I know these.
I know.
Nate, please wear that shirt on Friday.
Yeah? Okay.
Oh, never mind. I'll
bring it. I want to see it in person. I want to feel it.
That's very sick, dude. Yeah, that's such a cool shirt.
You're getting it now.
Dude, yeah. Thanks again, Casey. This thing's fucking awesome.
Casey, hey, he's a real nigga.
Real nigga. Yeah. Okay, so anybody else? Because I can just go ahead, move ahead.
I want to yell to table. I want to go table one. Status report on patient 183.
Patient 183, deceased.
That was Frank, right?
No.
Wasn't Frank 183?
385 was Daigle, so I imagine Frank would be higher up in the numbers, probably.
Oh, he was 383. Yeah. Sorry.
383, yep.
Oh, that's what I meant. Oh, well. My bad.
Deceased.
Yeah.
Do I get okay. Oh, no. Yeah, if you tell them patient 383, status, they say...
That's what I meant to say, yeah.
Oh, gotcha, gotcha. Okay, yeah, so...
table one, patient status on patient 383.
Patient status, improving. Stabilized. Heartbeat, regular. Blood pressure, not abnormal.
As he's saying that, can I fucking throw Peter on the table? Try to be something I don't fucking know.
Patient, not human.
What?
Running data. And you see that, like, the robot, it has, like, a container of his blood, and it goes back towards the wall to its, like, to its bay, and it sticks its arm into the wall, and after a few seconds, you can see, like, kind of, like, lights running through as it's, like, computing or something, and it says, patient 383. Patient 383. Not member of Vault 108.
Oh, shit.
Time to dismiss.
Am I still looting things? Probably.
Yeah.
Okay.
Table two, explain patient dismissal.
Patient dismissal. Patient will be taken to... Patient will be deposited to biological refinement and food systems.
Yeah, I turn off all the robots.
Okay. So these two panels are across the room, and you shut off one of them, mm-hmm. and it's like it's the one that's still doing like surgery. So it like it goes, and it's like arms stay right in place, and its little like turning blade that it was about to like put to his leg for whatever part of its fucking surgery it was doing just starts to slow down until it stops. Mm. The other one turns and it says, "What are you doing? Surgery in procedure. Surgery now. Must
get rid of patient. Must move." Biological refinement. Biological.
Patient 185, not resident of Vault 108. And you see that it's double hands. They just split open, and those two, and like a surgical blade comes out of like either wrists. And it goes running. It comes like just storming right towards you, John.
Towards me?
Yes.
Ah, fuck.
And you can see that this robot's gone fucking haywire.
I'm going to duck behind the control panel.
Okay.
Well, shit.
All right, yeah, so it starts. It goes right towards you, but it ends up going into the control panel.
Can I smack it? With
okay, so it has its arms stuck in the control panel right now.
Yes.
I want to plunge my gauntlets into its shoulder joints.
Oh, gotcha. You risky.
Roll it.
That's my two arms.
Rolling.
15, oh, 17. Shit.
Those are both going to hit. Okay, roll for damage.
Shit, dude, the hell is seeing you rolling.
Hold on.
And they hate
me. They see me rolling. They hate him.
They see me rolling with Satan.
Okay, and like this is gonna be weird, but I'm gonna slip my hands out of the gauntlets, hoping to stall its arms.
Oh shit!
I'm gonna leave the gauntlets in.
Yeah. I see what you mean. Yeah, so yeah, you punch into it, and both of those cut into its arms. The gauntlets stick in deep, the bladed gauntlets. Let's remind the listeners. Yeah, so your bladed gauntlets, they chunk into these tube arms. You can see the arms are damaged. You release your hands from inside of them, because you're basically just holding on to bars inside of the gauntlets.
Yeah, exactly.
And highs or lows?
Let's go highs.
All right. Yeah, so the blades stay in there, and you can see that its arms like are attempting to lift the cutters, but it's kind of just like jerking, and one of the arms actually turns onto itself and like just cuts the arm further and and falls limp.
Again, if I have a movement, I'm going to rush towards the other control panel. If not, then I guess I'm where I'm at.
Yeah, no, you can rush to the other control panel.
Dope.
Yeah, and you only have to hit the button, so you're able to press it. Yeah, because you'd already set it up.
That's what I do. Yeah, awesome.
Yeah.
Dope.
Well, good idea setting those up, John.
Very nice.
That was very nice.
Best play I've ever done in this game. Oh my god,
that was pretty sick. That was actually pretty sick.
Hell yeah.
I can see it. That's pretty
John
sick.
Saves the day from the last like murderous robot. John's rocked up. John's fucking pushing diamonds below the belt.
That was one of the best plays I've ever done. That makes me so happy.
So here, Frank is laying on the table, and he is like 80% patched up. His foot is facing in the right direction, and you can see that it's like partially splinted. It looks like they were about to perform further surgery before they were interrupted and now shut down. But you all come together around the table, and you see that there's like some blood around the table. You see these robots. You see the burning puddle of oil, and you prize your gauntlets from the shut down robot, and one of its arms just falls limp to the ground, full of like metal surgical supplies that begin spilling out of its back end. And Edgar comes back looking however he's looking with arms full of supplies. Peter's laying on the other table also knocked out. And you're all in whatever state of like exhaustion and worry after this crazy fucking day. This has been all one day that you've been in this vault. That you fought the fishmen. And like dealt with all these robots and everything. So we'll leave you here in the darkness of the med bay, lit by Peter's flare and lit by this pile of burning oil as you all come together around the table that Frank and Peter are laying on. I imagine Daigle standing near Peter's bed and the rest of you will be around Frank. And we'll leave it there for today in, I guess, Vault 108.